This is Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
The tour days are long gone. Now it's game on. Folks, this one's for bragging rights around Houston. It's a pigskin classic you can't miss. Texas Southern takes on Prairie View A&M right now. We welcome you to College Football Primetime on ESPNU, presented by Citi. At Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, for the 25th annual Labor Day Classic, matching the Texas Southern University Tigers and the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. I'm Carter Blackburn with former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr. This may be the kickoff for Prairie View A&M and Texas Southern, but already a critical matchup in the SWAC.
Yes, it's a very critical matchup to start off with, and you always want to play big in your first game, but this game has added pressure because it's your crosstown rival, and it's also a conference game. If you take a look at the Prairie View Panthers, they fully expect to win the SWAC title this year. They finished 9-1 and second behind Grambling, but they feel like they have a team that can come back this year and win their first SWAC title since 1964.
Two campuses separated by about 50 miles. They've been playing since the 40s. Lots of ups and downs throughout the years for these two, but 2009 could be a pretty good year for both the Tigers and the Panthers.
Yeah, I think so. Texas Southern, they returned to an old guy, Johnny Coles. He was their quarterback back in the early 80s, so he knows what it takes to beat Prairie View A&M on a regular basis. But his goals are bigger than that. He feels like he has a team this year that can compete in the Western Division of the SWAC, and they would really like to put a good effort out here tonight and get the season started on a positive note.
In fact, 25 years ago, next door at the Astrodome, Johnny Cole was the starting quarterback in the first ever Labor Day Classic. Texas Southern has dominated the rivalry, but four out of the last five meetings, including the last two, have gone to the Panthers from Prairie View A&M. So now it's Johnny Cole leading the hobo offense for the Texas Southern Tigers. What is that? We'll tell you about it when we kick off Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M next.
Years of culture and tradition have passed through the hands of those before us. It is now our duty to honor the heritage given to us and uphold it for those next in line.
We on top, never underrated. We on top, never underrated.
We will take the field and we will be tomorrow's legends. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by Citi. Citi never sleeps. And in part by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, home of the NFL's Houston Texans, and home tonight for the 25th annual Labor Day Classic, matching Texas Southern, coached by Johnny Cole, now in his second season coaching his alma mater and what he calls his dream job. Matched up with Henry Frazier III, now in his sixth season at Prairie View A&M, which is about 50 miles northwest of downtown Houston in the Texas Southern University campus. Last year, 9 wins, and yet Eddie, Coach Frazier, very adamant about saying 9-1, so what? We didn't win a championship, we didn't get a ring.
Well, you know, the only team in the SWAC that Frazier has not beaten since he's been at Prairie View is the Grambling State Tigers. And Grambling has been the team to represent the West the last 2 years. So, of course, they have to get over that Grambling hump. But it all starts today with this big game against Texas Southern.
Texas Southern will get the football first. Pedro Ventura will kick it off for Prairie View A&M. Anthony Webb and the very dangerous William Osborne, number 2, back to receive for Texas Southern. It's Texas Southern in maroon, Prairie View A&M in the gray with purple helmets. In Houston, the 25th annual Labor Day Classic underway. Osborne will get a touch at the 5. Already a penalty flag down on the play in the backfield as Osborne dropped at the 22.
And I think that personal foul is going to go against Texas Southern. They took a shot at the Prairie View kicker as soon as he kicked the football. We'll see if that's the call.
Five seconds in, already a penalty on the opening kickoff. Ventura, the kicker, was involved, but like you said, Eddie, looks like he took the brunt of the penalty.
Coach Frazier already in midseason form. He's getting out there and getting it mixed up with the referees early on.
And quite obviously, the officiating crew taking a while to sort this one out. Charles Lewis is our referee.
See one of the frontline guys for Texas Southern. When Pedro Ventura, after he kicked off, he was very aggressive with his block, and I think he may have just a roughing the kicker.
Personal foul on the kicking team. That penalty is declined. First down.
That's a pretty interesting call, because what they're saying is that Pedro Ventura, the kicker, I guess actually got the personal foul, but seems like he was the guy who took the shot from the Texas Southern blocker.
And Prairie View A&M called for the penalty, so we see Arvell Nelson out to quarterback, Texas Southern. Cleveland, Ohio. He is a transfer from Iowa. Went through spring practice with Texas Southern, handing off on first down to Joseph Warren. So Arvell Nelson gets the start at QB. There was a question up until yesterday evening for head coach Johnny Cole as to whether it was going to be Nelson or Gino Simone, the transfer from College of the Sequoias. On second down, another handoff. Warren bounces it to the outside and picks up about seven. Take a look at the Texas Southern impact players, two on offense and one on defense for the Tigers.
Yeah, you have to start with William Osborne. This guy's an All-American and can do everything from a punt returner and receiver. Ricky Dixon, transfer from LSU, big receiver. And Dewan Fogum, he led the team in tackles last year. All three of those guys should have very big days, but especially Osborne.
Third down and three. Nelson dumps it short, complete for a first down. As Texas Southern moves the chains. Starting lineups are at the top of your screen. Andrew Thomas makes the grab. The long snapper who was in on the package picks up the first down. First and 10 for Texas Southern. Tight end goes in motion, hand off to Warren again. Not much running room. Ronaldo Revolta on the tackle.
Here, just an inside handoff, not a lot of running room. Texas Southern really wants to get going, get things going in the air, but of course they're still going to try to run a couple plays just to keep this Prairie View defense honest.
This is second down and 10. The screen is incomplete, intended for Warren. Flag on the play. You mentioned the passing attack that Texas Southern wants to get going. The hobo offense has been Johnny Cole's trademark. It stands for high octane, big play offense. Stems from his days when he was quarterback at Texas Southern.
but not on the playing field. It came from Tecmo Bowl. He and his Tiger teammates love playing Tecmo Bowl. They said, Johnny, you know, this is like the hobo offense, and it stuck with them
look
all these
the
years.
Offense number one, 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, second down.
Yeah, but I tell you what, everywhere that Coach Coles has been, he's always had some very big players. I mean, from wide receivers and quarterbacks, he had Leon Murray at Tennessee State, Tavarius Jackson at Alabama State, Darnell Kennedy, all of these guys led their conference in passing. So he feels like he has a good one in Arvell Nelson, and he's going to give him a chance to throw the football.
Second down and 20 with five wide. Another flag. So I wonder on those old Tecmo Bowl games who Johnny Cole was going with.
And I was always a Denver Bronco guy.
False start. Offense number 28. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
I mean, the Tecmo Bowl in those days would have had like the Warren Moon, Ernest Givens run and shoot Oilers too.
There you go. You know, I played with those guys well across the street from here in the old House of Pain, the Astrodome.
Second down and 25 now for Texas Southern. Nelson over the middle, complete to William Osborne, who gets leveled as he comes across the middle. Chris Ford leads the charge.
Yeah, but William Osborne, this kid is extremely tough. I mean, he can take a licking. He's a punt returner, kick returner, very dangerous with the football. He has no fear about catching these little crossing routes, and he knows how to keep turning it up the field. And he's not afraid of contact. He's just not going to go down after he catches the football.
The senior from Marshall, Texas. This is third down and 17. Nelson stepping up over the middle. It is caught for a Texas Southern first down to Andrew Thomas again.
I really like the way Arvell Nelson is stepping up in the pocket here, and he finds a window to deliver this football, and a good throw and a catch and a big first down for Texas Southern, and they're on the move.
First and 10 again. Handoff goes to Warren again, trying to bounce it outside. Drag down. There's another penalty flag after the tackle from Joe Fontenot.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 14. It's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Of course, there's no more incidental contact with the face mask, but I think that would have been a 15-yard variety either way. Prairie View just a little bit anxious in this game. I mean, Texas Southern is moving the football well, and guys are getting a little frustrated, but you have to keep your composure and play within yourself.
Call was on 14, but it looks like Fontenot was the one to grab the face mask. Nonetheless, 15-yarder, first and 10. Texas Southern now at the Prairie View 35. Nelson, quick drop, throws the fade, and it is dropped. What would have been an interception by Adingapu, the free safety.
And that's one that you have to have. That's a missed opportunity for a big play by number three, Chris Adingapu. Arvell Nelson having a mix-up with the wide receiver, and as a free safety, just make the easy catch. Looked like he tried to get twisted around and have the old Willie Mays over the shoulder. He could have just went for the basket catch and tried to keep his feet in bounds.
A break for Texas Southern brings up second and 10. Nelson handing off again. This time, Marcus Wright picks up maybe a yard. Dalvin Nettles, the defensive tackle credited with the tackle.
Defensive coordinator, Heist Northern for Prairie View A&M. This is a situation where he tries to bring pressure, third and nine, a third and long situation. We'll see. You still have a young quarterback in Arvell Nelson. Maybe they can put some pressure on him to get him to do something out of his comfort zone.
30 penalty yards, 35 yards of total offense. And on third down and nine, an incomplete pass in the flat to the fullback Newsom. Brings up fourth down and nine, and the kicker Robert Hurst for Texas Southern. The range is about 40, this well outside his range then.
Yeah, but this is one of those situations, if you punt and it goes into the end zone, you're only going to get 15 net yards, so you might as well go for it on fourth down, and it seems like Johnny Coles is going to have that approach.
Empty backfield for fourth down and 9. Plenty of time for Nelson to throw. One pump, now he breaks it back, and it's almost picked again. Century got a hand on it.
Nelson, a lot of time to throw, very fortunate. I think if Century can make that catch clean, he may score with an interception return for a touchdown. A good pump fake gets everyone moving, but whenever you try to go across your body like that, across the field, it's always tough. The defenders can react fast.
Scoreless between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. ESPNU's coverage of college football continues on Thursday as the Florida A&M Rattlers face the Rams of Winston-Salem State. College football primetime on ESPNU and ESPNU HD Thursday, 7:30 Eastern. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Quick snap out of the timeout as Prairie View gets a playoff. No gain, and it'll already be second down and 10 on the first Prairie View A&M possession. Jay Bluford is the starting quarterback for Prairie View A&M, replacing the graduated Mark Spivey. Beat out K.J. Black in a QB battle. Second down and 10. Pressure coming from the Tigers, and here's a flag, and there's a second flag as Bluford was hit after a whistle by the blitzing John Dimps.
Prior to the snap, offside, defense, number 42. It's a 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And number 42, John Dempse, just tries to beat the snap count. This guy's going to be a pretty good player. He's a transfer from the University of Florida, very good-looking athlete at that outside linebacker position.
Second down and 5 for the Panthers. Pressure coming again. Handoff goes to Michael Chasen, who breaks free near the 50. For the Prairie View A&M Panthers, the impact players.
Yeah, you have to start with Donald Babers. This guy was the only guy in the conference to have over 1,000 yards rushing last year. Michael Jason, who we just saw, only a freshman last year, coming back for his sophomore season. Look for big things out of him. And finally, the linebacker, Ronaldo Revelta, third generation playing here at Prairie View A&M, has a lot of brothers here.
Jason sits out on the first down and 10, so Babers back in the backfield along with Bluford. And this is Babers getting his first touch of 2009, shoved back, minimal gain on first down. Starting lineup at the top of your screen. And what a running back battle between Donald Babers, first Panther since 88 to rush for over 1,000 yards, and yet Michael Jason playing with an excellent fall camp, really pushing Donald Babers for time in the backfield.
Well, I tell you what, Coach Frazier really likes to run the football, so it's enough touches for both of these guys to have a very good year. I wouldn't be surprised if both of them end up with close to 1,000 yards apiece.
Second down and 9 after a minimal gain for Babers on first. Give it back to Jason on second down, and again only a yard, so a good start defensively for the front 7 for Texas Southern.
Now, we saw all of the big time passes and the exotic formations by Johnny Coles and the hobo offense. Well, now we're just going to get back to basic Texas football from Prairie View. Coach Frazier wants to play smash mouth football. He has a big offensive line. All of those guys have been redshirted. They're juniors and seniors, so they've been together for a couple years, and they may get into some different formations, but at the end of the day, they want to run the football in Prairie View.
And yet facing third down and 8 from midfield and an empty backfield. Stepping up, Bluford leaves it high. It's picked. DeMarcus Washington will take it all the way back. Touchdown, Texas Southern. A 56-yard INT for TD.
Quarterback Jay Buford, he lets this one get ahead of him. And just a great job of reacting by number 32, DeMarcus Washington. This guy had 5 interceptions last year as a freshman, was SWAC Freshman of the Year and Newcomer of the Year, and you can see why. He just read the quarterback's eye and react to the ball, and now Texas Southern has a 6-0 lead.
Robert Hirsch for the extra point. Flag before the PAT.
Tushin. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Re-kick.
What a start for the Texas Southern defense. They stop the run, force third and long, and get the pick for a touchdown.
That's exactly how you want to play this Prairie View Panther team. Be physical against the run and get them into obvious passing situations.
Hirsch's PAT makes it a 7-0 start for Texas Southern. Nice.
.300 all-purpose yards is an accomplishment many athletes won't surpass in a career. For William Osborne, that's the numbers he put up in one season.
His 2,308 all-purpose yards is the highest total ever in a season at TSU and ranked him second in the nation on his way to receiving honors as an All-American.
So, I mean, I worked hard after practice, before practice, came on time, did whatever it took to be the All-American. I like being the underdog, so I have nothing to lose but to get out there and prove to them that I'm the best. The thing that I haven't accomplished is graduate. I plan on graduating next year within four years and trying to go to the NFL, which is every college student's dream.
More from Daniel coming up later on another ESPNU Campus Connection about the Ocean of Soul at Texas Southern University. There's William Osborne, Henry Frazier, Prairie View A&M head coach, said we have to keep eyes on him, one of the most explosive players in the SWAC.
Yeah, he had a great game last year in this Labor Day Classic, and this guy is very exciting, not just from a punt returner and kick return aspect, but also as a receiver. And was an indoor 200-meter sprint champ for the track team, so you know he can run.
After the interception for a touchdown, Texas Southern will kick it off. Robert Hirsch with a short kick. Bobbled. Wheaton has to fall on it at the 22 to make sure Prairie View keeps the football.
I'd expect Coach Frazier and just never had it. Very fortunate they were able to get back on that football.
Joseph Fontenot was the player who bobbled it, and then his fellow kick returner Wheaton able to jump back on top. So Prairie View A&M, who threw an interception from the hands of Jay Bluford to DeMarcus Washington, and then obviously they get the football right back. From the shotgun, it's Jason who gets the first down handoff, and the Tigers continue to swarm for the football.
Yeah, Texas Southern is going to put 8-9 in the box because they realize that Prairie View wants to run first and pass second. And you can see here, they're going to be very physical up front. A little inside handoff. Good play by John Cole right there, 6'3", 290-pound senior. And these guys know that they have to stop this running game from Prairie View and force them into those passing situations.
Second down and 10. Bluford back to pass, completes it on the right side. Alonzo Rivolta, the redshirt freshman tight end, younger brother of the linebacker Ronaldo Rivolta.
And I like this call. Jay Buford just throwing a little quick pass out to the flat by his tight end. Let's get some run after catch yards. You have to really settle this guy down. I mean, Jay Buford came into this game with 7 career passes and 3 interceptions, which is not a very good ratio, and he already has thrown another interception today. So you just want to settle him down, let him complete a couple of sharp passes, and get his confidence going.
Last third down for the Panthers was the INT for TD. Now it's third down again. Washington, who made the play, will be at the bottom of your screen. Third down and 4. Bluford is going to tuck it and run and picks up the first down. Bluford with the block to break it to midfield. A 22-yard pickup on third down and 4.
Yeah, great decision by Bluford. Guys are covered downfield. Hey, let me convert and get the first down. Once he gets into the Texas Southern territory, he makes a couple people miss, get a couple good blocks. Big game for Prairie View on third down. That should really settle him down. He got a little contact, took a hit after that play. Maybe he's ready to play now.
First and 10 from the 50. Out of the eye backfield, Michael Jason pushes the pile to the 45. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime at Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, as the Texas Southern University Panthers take on the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. Carter Blackford, along with former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr. Scoreboard says 7-0 Texas Southern. And what do you think about the early effort through nearly 10 minutes of play for Texas Southern?
Well, if you're Johnny Coles in Texas Southern, you have to be ecstatic. Your defense has stepped up, made some big plays, your offense moved the ball a little, and you got a big interception return for a touchdown. So you definitely came into this game the underdog, but you're going toe-to-toe with the Prairie View Panthers, and you're matching up against Prairie View from the physical aspect. This Prairie View offense has been known to wear opponents down.
Big penalty call there was unsportsmanlike conduct against Texas Southern. Bringing the football to just inside the 30. Bluford hands off to Donald Babers, and the junior from Houston's Westbury High School picks up 3. Log on to Facebook today, search ESPNU, and become a fan. Post your best tailgating photos and comments. We may use them on Inside the Polls Monday, 6 o'clock on ESPNU HD. Will you accept a friend request?
You know, I have about 75 unaccepted friend requests. I need to get around to accepting some people now.
Second down and 6. Texas Southern aggressive with the run blitz again on second down.
Yeah, another big third down play for Prairie View. We'll see if they opt to come with another running play or a play action pass. You know, Texas Southern is playing so physical and close to the line of scrimmage, at some point you have to think that play action is going to bite them. They have an opportunity to make a big play, but from Prairie View.
Call it third down and 3. First down marker right around the 20. Pressure up the middle. Bluford is sacked. DeJuan Fulgham, the preseason all-SWAC middle linebacker, went unblocked.
And I tell you what, he led this team in tackles last year and also had 5 sacks. This guy is a go-getter. High octane, big energy guy, and hey, just a blitz right up the middle. You see the containment on the outside. Quarterback never stood a chance. That was a well-designed blitz because he came from the right side and looped around the center, so nobody was there to pick him up, especially with that empty backfield. Now Prairie View is going for it on fourth down.
Frazier will take a timeout before the fourth down. Welcome back to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by Citi as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. We're at the 25th annual Labor Day Classic in Houston, Texas. The Tigers of Texas Southern battling the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. And already some critical miscues.
Yeah, here you see a ball that was just overthrown. Should have been intercepted by Prairie View. Didn't make the play. Another one At Prairie View, had two hands on it, couldn't do it. But here, at number 32, DeMarcus Washington, he takes advantage of his opportunity. He gets an interception for a touchdown, and that's where we stand. 7-0, Texas Southern over Prairie View.
And now Prairie View A&M facing fourth down and 10. And out of the timeout, it appears that they will keep Bluford, the quarterback, on the field going forward on fourth down and 10 from right around the 30. Bluford down the middle on fourth down, completing, and a huge fourth down conversion for Prairie View A&M. Sean Stevens makes the grab.
Hey, you look at number 7, Robert Joseph of Texas Southern. He's coming into your pitcher. He just couldn't come across the field enough to help out, but that was just a nice executed play by Prairie View, a skinny post, and realizing that you only needed 10 yards for the first down, just get 12 and make the catch.
Last year, Prairie View A&M had 9 fourth down conversions. Obviously, that's their first of 2009. First and 10 out of the eye. Babers trying to turn the corner. A little stiff arm for Curtis Thomas, who shoves him out of bounds.
Other than one big run by Michael Jason, I mean, this Prairie View offensive attack hasn't had much going. Look at there, just a good job by Texas Southern stretching that thing out, and the cornerbacks and safeties coming up in run support, because they realize Donald Babers is the guy that you have to stop. You have to focus on this Prairie View rushing attack.
126 yards for Babers last year in this matchup. Second and 9. Jason stretched out, rather Babers stretched out. Flag on the play as John Demps leads the charge.
Here, just a zone read. Babers tries to take it and goes sideways and can't get anything going. Once again, that Texas Southern defense is there.
Holding, offense number 66. Penalty is declined. Third down.
The early MVP of the Labor Day Classic may be referee Charles Lewis.
Tell you what, he's trying to compete with us as far as airtime.
Play stands, bringing up third down and long. Call it third down and 18. Bluford to the end zone. It is caught for a touchdown. What a grab. Osazi Edei with his 8th career touchdown catch.
I tell you what, this was all Gabe Osazi Edei. Great call. He just throw it up as fourth and long, and he just stretches up and makes that catch. 6'1", 190-pound senior, Austin, Texas, Crockett High School. He has to feel good after that reception. Big play by Prairie View.
Kick by Venturi is good, and Prairie View A&M evens it 7-all. On a heck of a touchdown grab by Osazi Edei.
And Carter, this is the classic example. Hey, you have him covered, but unless you make the play, it really doesn't matter. And that's what happens with Gabe Osazi Edei. Hey, you have me covered, but you can't stop me. I can beat you one-on-one. I can outjump you and make the play. Just a great job of playing basketball in the back of the end zone. And Coach Frazier has to love that for a guy who likes to ground pound and run the football. You can get a big play out of your passing game to tie up the score in the first quarter. It gives your team a lot of confidence.
4 touchdown grabs a year ago, career highs in catches, yards, and touchdowns, and an offense that mainly runs the football. But you see, they have a big weapon at wideout as well, in number 82.
You know, and I've watched this kid over the last couple of years, and Edei, he's just been getting better and better each year. Now, they really are going to try to focus him in the passing game. And you have a young quarterback in Jay Buford, who only came into this season with 7 career passing attempts. He needs a guy like that to go up and make a play. I mean, he wasn't open. It was a good throw, but even a better catch. So you want to work with a young quarterback. Hey, just throw it up, give me a chance to make a play, and I'll make you look good. And that's what Edei did.
How big is that for Prairie View A&M? You throw an INT for a touchdown on your first offensive possession, follow that up with a touchdown drive.
Yeah, I mean, you have to come right back, especially for the quarterback who's a young guy, Jay Buford, first career start. You need him to have something positive happen to him early.
Osborne in the return game from inside the 10. Dancing along the sideline, shoved out near the 40. And a taste of the explosiveness of William Osborne. Last year, the 24th annual Labor Day Classic. Osborne in the return game had one of the biggest plays, a 45-yard return for Texas Southern. But too much Donald Babers, 126 yards, two rushing touchdowns in the game for Prairie View A&M, 34-14. The Panthers took last year's meeting against Texas Southern. Prairie View has won four of the last five meetings, which certainly breaks from the historical trend. Joseph Warren, the first down handoff. Texas Southern coach Johnny Cole seemed a little bit perturbed that all of a sudden Prairie View A&M has the upper hand in this matchup.
Well, keep in mind, when Johnny Coles was here and they were playing Prairie View, this was just a game that you knew you were going to win. It was just a matter of, hey, how many touchdown passes am I going to throw? But man, how things have changed since Coach Frazier has arrived at Prairie View. They are really competing for this Western Division title.
Second down and 10 with the I backfield. Marcus Wright, minimal gain. Of course, Prairie View A&M infamously had the 80 straight losses from 89 to 98. Henry Frazier has turned this program around, and interestingly enough, I asked him yesterday, all right, why did you want the Prairie View A&M job? He says, you kidding me? This is the greatest opportunity in college sports. 63 scholarships, full coaching staff, and when you win a few games at Prairie View, everyone says, you're doing a heck of a job.
Yeah, and all fairness to those coaches during that 80-game losing streak, Prairie View, they weren't giving out any athletic scholarships, and that program was really hurt by that. So he's gotten a lot of support now.
Third down for Nelson, slipping out of pressure. Chased some more and dropped, finally, by Chris Ford. So a stop from the Prairie View A&M defense. The Panthers get a stop. We're even at 7. Seven all in the 25th annual Labor Day Classic in Houston, Texas, Monday evening. Catch two college football shows on ESPNU, first at 5 Eastern Crunch Time. We'll deliver the entire closing minutes and moments of all the significant and close college football games from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, host Lowell Galindo, analyst Tom Luganville, and Tommy Tuberville will dissect and analyze the new polls and preview the next week's matchup on Inside the Polls, presented by 76. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Punt coming up for Texas Southern. It will be Solomon kicking it away to Anthony Whedon for Prairie View A&M. After the three and out from Texas Southern, high punt, Whedon calls for the fair catch. Makes the grab around the 37.
That's a good three and out for the Prairie View Panther defense. We'll see if Texas Southern can come out and respond and try to match defenses with Prairie View. I mean, Prairie View has a very good defense traditionally throughout the years. And Texas Southern, I like the way they've been physical against this Prairie View's rushing attack. But I think at some point, Prairie View's going to try a play-action pass and try to take another shot deep, especially after that great catch by Osazi Edei in the previous drive.
Last drive resulted in that touchdown for Prairie View A&M. Two possessions, both resulted in touchdowns. One was for the opponent. Jason gets the first down carry, and the Tigers are waiting for him. Fulgham leads the way, along with Rashad Hunt.
Johnny Coles told us, he said, I feel like we can match up physically with the Prairie View Panthers this year. They felt like they got pushed around a little bit in the second half with that Prairie View running game. They had 60 guys here committed to the offseason workout program, and that really helped Texas Southern. You can tell those guys up front, Melanson, John Cole, and the linebacker Fulgham, they're not getting knocked off the ball. They're going toe-to-toe with this Prairie View offense.
30 freshmen saw the field last year for Texas Southern. A lot more transfers this year for the Tigers as Coach Cole wanted to get older immediately. A flag before the second down and 10 play.
Delay of game. Offense number 11. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
You know, one negative about Prairie View last year, they were last in the conference in penalties. You know, they had averaged 104 yards of penalties per game. I know that's something that Coach Frazier really is trying to work on, but not going too well just yet this first game.
Room for improvement. Second down at 15. Pass complete to Jason out of the backfield, who is leveled as soon as he makes the grab by Shamari Clemens, the strong side linebacker.
That's just a great form tackle. That's how you practice it. Get a guy right in your sights, look at that. You roll your hips, follow through, and you knock him back for a loss of two. That's a great tackle by Shamari Clemens. Lucky that he was able to hold on to the football.
Tigers have forced Prairie View A&M into another third down and long. Third down and 17. Luford just does get the snap off. Handing off to Jason, and he only picks up two on third down and 17.
Yeah, good defensive series by Texas Southern. They came onto the field and held serve, and now Prairie View will be forced to punt and get their offense back on the field. And this Texas Southern defense is really stepping up. They're playing physical. They're getting them to third and long situations, and that's not what Prairie View excels in. So the game plan that Coach Kevin Ramsey has drawn up this year for the Texas Southern defense is working out pretty well.
Ventura will kick it away to William Osborne and Anthony Webb. And flags again.
Illegal substitution on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
There were 12 men on the field.
They said, if you're not cheating, you're not trying. Hey, the referees, it's the first game. Maybe they miscounted and get away with an extra guy.
So now Prairie View A&M on fourth down, Ventura punting it away. Webb lets it bounce. Now turns it upfield. Webb wrestled down at the 40. Well to go in the first half of the 25th annual Labor Day Classic. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime. SWAC Conference Football presented by Citi as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week at Reliant Stadium in Houston. Tie ball game between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. Johnny Cole leading the Texas Southern University Tigers. Second year as head coach at his alma mater. Three and out. Last time his offense took the field. First down and 10 now from Texas Southern zone 41. Arvell Nelson, toss right to Gilbert. Flags on the play. For the offsides.
Yeah, that's one of those penalties you can't have. I mean, you've been the most penalized team in the conference last year, something that Prairie View really has to tighten up. I mean, they feel like they can win this SWAC title this year, but you can't win it with those type of penalties. There's too many good teams in the conference for you to hurt yourself, and now you're starting off giving the team a first and five.
Nelson under center. Gilbert tries to spin away from the defense, but nothing doing. Devin Boyd meets Martin Gilbert in the backfield.
And that play looked like it was a misalignment by the tailback, Gilbert. I mean, he's going one way, the quarterback's looking for him. I mean, I've seen some counter plays, but they don't take that long to develop. In Prairie View, they take advantage of that. Now you're in a second and long situation when you just had a great opportunity at first and five.
So Gilbert comes out of the game. Marcus Wright now the tailback next to Arvell Nelson on second down and 12. Nelson swings it out to right in the flat. Slips out of a tackle. Met at the 45.
Tell you what, that was a great job by Nelson making people miss. Here, this has got just a little extension of the running game. Hey, two guys right there, I make both of them miss. I run hard and finish up the play, and I put my team in a third and five situation. That's a player doing something above the X's and O's. That play should have been stopped for a three-yard loss, and he turns it into a seven-yard gain.
Third down and six. Play fake. Incomplete. The intended receiver, Newsom, tripped a little bit as the ball arrived.
I think that caused the incompletion. You had two receivers in the same area, but Arvell Nelson had his guy, and once he stumbled, he wasn't able to make that catch, and now the punt team will have to come on once again for the Tigers.
Back-to-back three and outs for the Texas Southern offense. The only touchdown, only points for Texas Southern came from the defense. When DeMarcus Washington had the interception return for a touchdown. Hirsch will punt it to Anthony Wheaton. Didn't get the playoff in time.
Prior to the snap, delay of game, offense. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
Try it again with Hirsch punting to Wheaton.
And Wheaton is the dangerous return man. I know Will Osborne gets all the accolades in this football game, but hey, Wheaton can take this thing and make something happen.
Correction, it's Stephen Solomon punting for Texas Southern. Wheaton, the return man. High kick, Wheaton will let it bounce and it rolls out around the 30. Two possessions ago, Prairie View A&M facing a critical fourth down.
Yeah, doing it through the air. This is the team that's known for running the football, but here a critical fourth down conversion by Jay Buford. Then he comes back on another fourth down play to Gable Sizey Eddie I. And hey, he just steps up and say, I'm bigger than you and I can make the catch to tie up the ball game at 7-7. I mean, this passing attack doesn't get a lot of credit for the Panthers, but so far it's really kept them in this football game as Texas Southern has been geared up to stop that running game.
These were the numbers from Gabe Osazi-Edii a year ago. Those were all career highs. He has a touchdown grab at 09, his only catch of the game so far. Pressure coming on Bluford on first down. He's looking long for Osazi-Edii. Incomplete, no flag as the freshman corner Anthony Webb.
And I think Frazier has a good beef with the field judge there because Anthony Webb definitely had some jersey on that play, which was smart on his part because he was beat. He's like, hey, you're not going to catch a second touchdown on me, but the referee missed it. Hey, second down. Taking another shot deep, it worked last time. You can go up and you can see the contact.
Second down, back to the ground. Babers tries to bounce it outside, leans forward for a 5-yard gain.
Now, Prairie View is going to be patient with their running attack. When you're talking about a team that last year had over 172 rushing yards per game. So they're going to be patient. Even if you stop them in the first quarter, second quarter, they're going to continue with that big offensive line, a bunch of red shirt juniors and seniors, they're going to try to pound you. But now we're in a third down and five by the passing situation, maybe.
Three wide, Babers in the backfield next to Bluford. Flag before the third down play goes off.
Prior to the snap, full start. Offense number 66. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime at Reliant Stadium, Houston, Texas, as the Texas Southern University Panthers battle the Texas Southern Tigers battle the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. I'm Carter Blackburn, along with former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr. And a third down and 10 coming up now for Prairie View A&M. Bluford looking long again for Osazi. Eddie I just slips out of his fingers.
And I tell you, number 12, Anthony Webb for Texas Southern is having his hands full today with Osazi. Eddie I just off of his fingertips and the potential to be a very big play. Hey, I like the throw and almost with the catch. Great job. Good effort, just couldn't get it done. But I tell you what, this quarterback, Jay Buford for Prairie View, is putting up some nice balls, and obviously Osazi Edie is his main target.
Ventura nearly has it blocked. Gets it away to Osborne. Backing up to the 15. Flag on the play. Osborne dragged down at the 18.
That was a great punt by Pedro Ventura. I thought he may have outkicked his coverage at first with the hang time. Prairie View defenders had enough time to get down there and corral a very dangerous returner in William Osborne.
On the return, blocking the back, number 13 of the return team. A penalty will be enforced half the distance to the goal. First and 10, Texas Southern.
Explosive plays in the first quarter to make this a 7-7 ball game. But midway through the second, it is the defense is dominating.
You know, in that first possession, Johnny Coles had a lot of success in the passing game, opening things up. We'll see if he goes back to that just a little bit more. We know he likes to throw it. But once they went to that running game, and Prairie View's been up to the task of stopping the run, maybe he'll get back to that wide open attack he had on that first series.
7-7 between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. Monday evening, catch two college football shows on ESPNU. First at 5 Eastern, Crunch Time will deliver the entire closing minutes and moments of all the significant and close college football contests from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, host Lowell Galindo, analyst Tom Luganville and Tommy Tuberville will dissect and analyze the new polls and preview the next week's matchups on Inside the Polls, presented by 76. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. First down and 10 for Texas Southern University. The Tigers have gone 3 and out on their last two possessions. So an eye backfield behind the junior QB, Arvell Nelson, transfer from Iowa. Martin Gilbert, the first down carry for about 3 yards.
You know, William Osborne has been very quiet on the offensive end. We'll see if they come up with a trick play or maybe something quick out to the flat just to get him back involved in the offensive aspect of this football game.
Osborne, number 2, lined up in the slot at the top of the screen for second down. Call it 2nd and 7. 4 wide for Nelson. Handing off out of the 4-wide package. Gilbert fumbles the football. Who's on top? Prairie View A&M recovers the fumble.
Tough break for Texas Southern. I mean, he had a more than enough yards for the first down. A very explosive run, but just couldn't hold it at the end. Here you're coming down here. Hey, that's just a great hit by Prairie View. Putting your helmet on the football. Every time that will cause a fumble, and a good job of recovering it. The Panthers are in scoring position once again.
Looks like Yvarian Richardson was the player who knocked it free. So Prairie View A&M gets the football with great field position at the 27.
Ball, first and 10, Texas Southern.
Wow. I've never seen that happen before when the referee gives it to one team and then you switch it back to the other. I mean, Frazier has a reason to be upset. Usually with whoever comes up with that ball at the bottom of the pile, there's the fumble. I mean, it's hard to say, it's impossible to say who has it right now. But usually when a referee comes in there and whoever he identifies with the ball right then, he gives it to that team and that's the end of the play. So I've never seen it where it went to one team and switched back.
There was a clear signal for Prairie View A&M, no doubt about that. And then the call reversed, Texas Southern hangs on to it. So
that's a huge break for Texas Southern, because if you give that ball to Prairie View in that situation, it's inside your 30-yard line and momentum has totally shifted. Now you get a second chance. You got a new set of downs. First down, you're up by the 28-yard line, and see if you can make something happen, if they can take advantage of that big break.
You ask his defense to make another stop. Second down and 8. Gilbert gets the football again. Max Century, the middle linebacker, there to stick it.
Last year, this Prairie View defense only giving up 65 rushing yards per game, first in the conference. They really excel at running the ball and stopping the run. So when Texas Southern tries to run, it's going against this defensive strength. We'll see if they want to do more things in the air and try to throw this football around a little bit more.
Prairie View A&M replacing the All-America linebacker Zach East. Third down and 8. Nelson pressured from behind and sacked on third down and 8. Ronaldo Revolta, the weak side linebacker, gets the sack.
Yeah, bringing pressure, coming around the corner on the outside, and he just never gave up on that play. Once he beat the tackle, he had explosiveness to get back into the play and get that sack, tried to get the forced fumble also. 55, great job with Ronaldo Revolta with the sack.
Solomon will punt to Anthony Whedon. And the Texas Southern offense continues to sputter. Flag on the play. Whedon lets it bounce and roll. Perhaps roughing the kicker.
Flag down, flag down.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. Number 18 of the defense. Automatic first down, 15-yard penalty.
And you can't just jump in the air and try to block the kick. You have to be aware of where the punter is. What's going to happen if I don't block the kick? Will I come down and rough the punter? And that's exactly what happened. An easy call by the referee. And once again, Texas Southern offense gets another break. Prairie View, once they had the fumble and they didn't have it, you give it back to the Texas Southern offense. You stop them on third down with a big sack, and now you rough the punter. You can't keep giving a team that many chances. Sooner or later, it's going to bite you.
Twice the Tigers appeared to be stopped. One time a fumble recovery overturned. Now roughing the kicker. And so for the third time on this possession, a new set of downs. High backfield on first and 10.
Play action.
Nelson looking long for Anderson, who drops it at the 20.
Tell you what, that was a great play call. You like to make those type of plays after a mistake by the other team. You come back with a play action. The defense just came back on the field. Deep ball, hey, right there. Should have been a touchdown. He makes that catch. He's still running into the end zone, and we're up by 7.
Instead, an incompletion, second and 10. Screen. Warren. Dancing near midfield, needed one more block. century makes the stop.
I tell you what, I like this Joseph Warren. He was a freshman last year. Now he's a sophomore coming back for a second year out of Madison High School, local product here in Houston, Texas. When you talk with Johnny Cole, you say, hey, we just have to recruit Texas. We don't have to go outside of the city limits. We just stay inside the Beltway and we get all the good players we want. And he's absolutely right. He's making a point of emphasis to try to keep those guys here in Houston.
Third down. Nelson goes right back to Anderson, who makes the grab, but he runs his route about 2 yards short of the first down.
Great job by Prairie View. The Panthers are stepping up on the defense. Just a little quick out route, good throw and catch, but even a better tackle to hold them short of that first down. Now they're going to have a fourth down attempt by Texas Southern.
Lester Butler makes the stop. Nelson and the offense stay on the field for fourth down. The hard count from Nelson. Panthers hold their water, so Texas Southern takes the timeout.
And I tell you what, with all of the offsides and the penalties that Prairie View has had, and I think that was a good try. Why not try to get them to jump offsides and maybe they'll line up offsides? But good discipline by Prairie View in that situation.
You saw Johnny Cole coaching up Joe Anderson after, on the same possession, a drop touchdown, and then he runs the route about 2 yards short of the first down marker.
Yeah, because it was third and five. You have to know, when I run my route, once I catch the football, I should already have the first down. So even if they make a great tackle, you should just fall down and you got the first down. So I think that's what Johnny Cole's upset about, because he knows that they should have a first down in this situation.
So Coach Cole's offense has yet to produce points. The only points on the board for Texas Southern came from the defense when DeMarcus Washington had the interception for a touchdown.
And they've been getting chance after chance on this drive. We don't know if they're going to punt it or try again on the fourth down in 2 or 3 yards. But hey, I tell you what, this offense has shown me some things. And they've been able to run the football well. They had a couple big plays in the passing game. They haven't put points on the board, but they've still been effective.
Punt formation, Solomon comes out after the timeout. Anthony Whedon to return it for Prairie View. Whedon calls for the fair catch and makes the grab near the 20. Johnny Cole was a quarterback at Texas Southern University, an assistant coach at Texas Southern, stints coaching at Southern, at Cincinnati, Alabama State, Arizona Western, Tennessee State, and the Hamburg Blue Devils in NFL Europe. And Johnny Cole says all of that was to get this job, the head coaching position at Texas Southern.
Yeah, he told us when he left in 1990, he left with the express purpose of wanting to come back here and become the head coach at his alma mater. He interviewed for the job twice. Both times they didn't hire him. The third time he said, hey, I'm not going to interview. If you want me, just hire me. And they did. I think it was a very good move.
Well, and keep in mind, 4 wins last year, it's a 4-8 season. That's not what Texas Southern wants. But the previous 4 years, they had won 4 games combined. So a 4-8 season was still a very productive first campaign under Johnny Cole's head coach. And there he is coaching up the offense right now in the middle of that huddle. He is the offensive coordinator as well for the Tigers. Panthers first and 10. Wide receiver screen to Whedon is snuffed out. Slips out of the first tackle from Webb. Robert Joseph finally brings him down. And some discussion afterward.
Wow. Tell you what, the quarterback took a very big shot for a four-yard loss. Mm.
Shamari Clemens, the strong side linebacker, laid the lick on Bluford. Obviously no flag.
I tell you what, this Texas Southern defense has come to play. Johnny Cole has always been known to put big points on the board and never had a team with a real good defense. Maybe this is the year he has a team with a good defense.
Second down and 14. Rolando Maloncom makes a nice stop on second down. The Big man from Letcher, Louisiana.
Yeah, Letcher, Louisiana. That's around my hometown in New Orleans, of course. And, hey, some good football down there. And a lot of those guys from Louisiana come over to Texas and play also. But you don't really have to leave the state of Texas to get a lot of good players. Here at Prairie View, once again, in a third and long situation, something that they're not very comfortable in.
Handing off on third down. Babers tries to stretch it out. Shoved out of bounds and maybe a little bit too late. Penalty flag after Curtis Thomas shoves out Donald Babers.
And you can see the speed of Babers. That play didn't look like it had much going, but he was still close to the first down. And once again, our referee will have to sort out the call at the end of this play.
Block in the back. Offense number 89. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Babers trying to get around the corner. Maybe that's the block in the back right there. But hey, good job by Texas Southern. These guys are playing hard defense. They're pursuing well. Playing physical, matching up with the intensity of this Prairie View offense. I like what I see from this Texas Southern defense so far.
They have forced three straight, three and outs.
And they scored on defense, which is always good. When you can score on defense, usually you win the football game.
Low kick from Ventura. It bounces. Osborne makes the grab. And Sykes makes the tackle. Otherwise, Osborne was getting ahead of steam behind him. William Osborne, the senior from Marshall, Texas. Second team All-SWAC as a wide receiver, All-American as a kick returner, although he has been held in check so far.
I mean, this guy was second in all of FCS in total yardage last year. Had 2,300 total yards from the turn and receiving and everything else he was able to do. But we'll see if they'll get him started this series.
The toss to Warren on first down. Warren slips out of the tackle. Inside the 35, flag near midfield. Johnny Cole told us yesterday, Joseph Warren is great in the open field. You saw it there. Hold will bring it back.
Yeah, the penalties are just really mounting up and hurting both teams. A wide receiver, you like that. You like when your wide receivers are making those blocks, but you have to teach
Holding
them to keep their hands inside.
Number 70. Penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Replay, first down.
Matt Hardrick, the left tackle in the open field.
Yeah, big guy. You know, those big guys, they're not used to being out in space. They tend to get their hands out wide and they're reaching and leaning. And you know, they do good when they're in the box and they can just reach and grab a guy and push him. But once you get out in space, everybody can see you, especially the referees.
Surely you're not suggesting that holding happens in tight.
Everybody.
Screen on first down. Andrew Thomas with his short gain to the 45.
Yeah, about a minute and a half left in this second quarter. And so we have an injured Panther down on the field. But if you're Coach Cole, you, of course, you want to score. But you don't want to leave enough time for this Prairie View offense in case you don't get it into the end zone. So that's why he's being somewhat conservative with his play calling so far.
Jamel Laban is the player slow off the field for Prairie View A&M. So the Panther training staff will try and help him off. The 64th overall meeting between Prairie View A&M and Texas Southern. It has been a rivalry dominated by Texas Southern, but as of late, and especially with the rebuilding job that Henry Frazier III has done, Prairie View A&M has dominated this rivalry. They've won four out of the last five meetings, including last year's matchup here at Reliant, 34-14. They've won the last two matchups.
Of course, everyone knows about Prairie View and early 90s when they had the losing streak and how Frazier has come along and helped to rebuild this program. But one thing you and I talked about before the game, Carter, was the last time Prairie View A&M and Texas Southern both had a winning record in the same season was 1967. That's almost 40 years of football where both of these programs haven't been able to get it done at the same time. So it'll be, I think this may be the year, this year or definitely next year, where TSU and Prairie View will both have that winning record in the same year, where this Labor Day Classic will have some bigger implications besides just in Texas, but also around the SWAC Conference.
Tied 7-7 here between the Tigers and Panthers. ESPNU's coverage of college football continues on Thursday. Florida A&M taking on Winston-Salem State. College football primetime on ESPNU and ESPNU HD Thursday, 7:30 Eastern. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com.
Yeah, that should be a real good MEAC matchup. I mean, Florida A&M, they have Coach Joe Taylor, who came over from Hampton, very successful up in Hampton. First year did some really good things at FAMU. I think now he has that team poised to compete for a MEAC title, and he's been a winner everywhere he's been.
You were mentioning the Prairie View A&M winning tradition, and, you know, folks don't remember that a lot because of the long losing streak, but they were in a power in the 50s and 60s. 10 SWAC titles all prior to 1964. They won 5 so-called Black College National Championships in the 1950s and 60s.
Yeah, I mean, you talk to some of the old timers and they talk about Prairie View with this tradition, and that's one thing you have to have, this reconnect. You have to have the younger players to know that, hey, this program has a history of doing things extremely well, and we're going to get it back to that level, and that's what Coach Frazier is trying to do.
Long walk off the field for Jamal Laban.
Yeah, very unfortunate when you have injuries. You never want to have them, you know, but on opening day is just always a bummer when you get hurt on that first game. You work so hard in the offseason, and Laban was actually late to training camp because he had a military obligation.
Second down and 12. Nelson over the middle to a wide open tight end, Jonathan Hanna.
Yeah, Jonathan Hanna, good looking kid, tight end. This is a guy that Coach Cole talked about. He's more of the receiver tight end. You can see why. Big kid, good target. Very good athlete.
Hurry up now from the Tigers. The clock winding down at the end of the first half. Warren finds room. Maybe a reason why. There's two flags on the play.
That initial call is holding against Texas Southern, so this won't count.
Clock stopped with 54 seconds, and obviously you see the
holding offense number 69. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, first down.
Timeouts available for both the Tigers and the Aggies, two each remaining, rather the Panthers.
I tell you what, the penalties are really hurting both teams. They're coming in, well, it's never a good time for a penalty, but they're coming in really crucial situations.
First down and 20. Nelson to the air again, incomplete, intended for Ricky Dixon. Now second down and 20, and Robert Hirsch, the Texas Southern kicker, ranges around 40. So that's a long way to go to get it to the 23. To get to within field goal range.
I think if you're number 8, Arvell Nelson, hey, you just take your time and complete a couple passes. You don't have to try to get in the full field goal range or get the first down on this play. Just get a completion and let your receivers work for you.
Second down and 20. Finally, the pressure comes. Here comes another flag. Nelson shoved down near the line of scrimmage. Arvell Nelson from Cleveland, Ohio.
Tell you what, good pass protection. Pocket starts to break down late, but Nelson is very, very shifty with that ball in his hand. He makes it look like he's throwing, able to make a couple people miss and pick up some yards. But of course, have another flag on the play, which seems to be a commonplace here in this first half.
Nelson's from Cleveland, an unabashed Browns fan. And Eric Mangini may not know who the quarterback for the Browns is, but he was pretty adamant about Brady Quinn yesterday, talking about the Cleveland Browns.
Yeah, I tell you what, we talked to Arvell Nelson yesterday, and you know, to me, the only people who are Browns fans are people that are from Cleveland.
There are two fouls on the play. Holding on the offense, number 77. as a 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. After the play, dead ball, personal foul, number 14 of the defense. That penalty will be enforced 15 yards, automatic first down.
On the linebacker, Chris Ford.
Yeah, that's not good. I mean, that stops the clock and it moves that ball 15 yards. And like you said, they were pretty close to field goal range and they're probably almost there now. Yeah, but talk about Nelson, the quarterback. I mean, of course, if you're from Cleveland, you love the Browns. I had to, you know, mess with him a little bit, but he said this is their year. He kind of didn't give me a guarantee, but he felt like the Browns were going to do something big this year. I said, okay.
Transferred from Iowa, but he transferred in time for the spring semester this past year, so he had spring ball and fall camp to get down the Texas Southern offense, replacing Bobby Reed, the former Oklahoma State QB, finished up with Texas Southern. Complete over the middle to William Osborne, and the first big play from Osborne as a wide receiver.
Yeah, you can see the toughness of Osborne. He jumps up and says, hey, hit me a little bit harder next time. Only 5'8", 170 pounds, but hey, this kid can make the catch and make the plays.
Tigers in the hurry-up offense, less than 30 to go before the half. First down, Nelson throwing, completing, and Haith gets out of bounds. So now you would be within field goal range, 19 seconds, a couple of timeouts, maybe time for a couple of shots.
Yeah, absolutely. You have to take a couple of shots at the end zone. But with the timeouts, you can still run the quarterback draw or screen or something quick. You don't have to throw it in the end zone. The whole field is wide open for Arvell Nelson right now.
Five wide on second down and one. Nelson rolling, throwing to the end zone. It is incomplete. Out of the reach of free safety, Anthony Beck.
And I tell you what, I like this Arvell Nelson kid. I mean, he's making good decisions with the football. Hey, no one's open, realizing the time and place in the football game. Hey, just get it out of bounds. You still have another down before fourth down. It's only third down. Give it another try.
Texas Southern takes a timeout. Nelson spent about a week in the hospital because of heat exhaustion. That set him back some, which caused Johnny Cole to at least say publicly that Gino Simone was going to be the starting quarterback for Texas Southern, but also perhaps some gamesmanship. Maybe, just maybe, some gamesmanship leading up to the Labor Day Classic.
Yeah, I mean, I know Johnny Cole for quite some time, and I can just tell by the excitement that he had talking about Arvell Nelson, I felt like that would be his starting quarterback.
You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime. We're at Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, as the Texas Southern University Tigers battle the Panthers at Prairie View A&M University. I'm Carter Blackburn, along with former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr. Tied 7-7 between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. Only points for Johnny Cole's Tigers came from the defense on an interception return for a touchdown. Now his offense in the waning seconds of the first half trying to put points on the board and take the lead before the break.
Yeah, but you know, if you're Texas Southern, you can still get the first down. So you can get the first down by running, call your timeout, and still have a couple shots to go into the end zone. So this will be a very interesting play call for Johnny Cole.
This is third down and one. Nelson spinning away to the end zone, incomplete. Intended for Brian Haight. So fourth down with 3 seconds left. Hirsch and the field goal unit come out.
Yeah, you know, I was up here in the booth saying, hey, maybe he should run for it. But that was actually a good decision by Nelson, realizing the amount of time he left in the football game. Had he taken off to run and got the first down, he probably wouldn't have any time left. So a good decision just throwing it away. Hey, let your kicker give you a chance to give you the lead going into the half.
Hirsch counting his blockers to make sure there's not 12 like previously. 32-yard attempt for the sophomore from nearby Pearland, Texas. No good. A 32-yard miss from Hirsch means we go to the half with a 7-7 tie between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M.
This is Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
ESPNU's College Football Primetime, the 25th annual Labor Day Classic from Houston, Texas, presented by Citi. Welcome back to Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, for the Labor Day Classic. 7-all between Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. As we take a look at the highlights from the first half, Johnny Cole's team came out hitting hard.
Yeah, it absolutely did. And here you see the freshman of the year from last year, DeMarcus Washington, with the big interception. Pick six, he returns it for the touchdown. Texas Southern took the early 7-0 lead. But hey, give Jay Buford credit. I mean, there's Baldwin coming back, the linebacker from Texas Southern, making a big play. But give Jay Buford credit here on a fourth down conversion. He comes back and completes the fourth down conversion. And then for the encore, he goes up top to number 82, Gable Sazi-Edei, for the touchdown. That ties it up at 7-all. A lot of penalties in this football game, but the teams are playing hard.
First half numbers, and look at all of the penalties. 17 penalties combined, 162 penalty yards. But also Prairie View A&M running the football. This is a team who last year averaged 173 yards a game, only 35 at the half.
So I think a lot of that credit has to go to the Texas Southern defense. They've really stepped up with that front seven. They've been physical. They haven't gotten manhandled or knocked off the football. And we'll see if Prairie View can turn that trend around. They're going to keep running the football. That's what they like to do. So they're going to pound it and see what they can come up with. But, hey, give credit to that Texas Southern defense, especially the front seven.
Hirsch kicks it off. Fontenot and Wheaton back to receive for Prairie View A&M. Short kick taken from near the 20. Run back by Michael Jason, the running back, one of the upmen in special teams. So 7-all, and again, the only points for Texas Southern came from the defensive side of the football. Jay Bluford threw the interception for a touchdown, the first time that Prairie View A&M took the field. But after that, very solid.
Yeah, nothing spectacular, the one interception, but hey, 5 of 8, the two big rushes for the 15 yards, and he has the touchdown pass.
Play fake on first down. Bluford down the middle, incomplete, intended for Sean Stevens.
I think that's a good call by Prairie View coming out with a little play action on first down. They've been trying to run the football, like you said, at the half, only 35 rushing yards because of all of the attention that they're giving to the rushing game by the Texas Southern Tigers. So you're going to have to get a couple plays, play actions on first down, open this thing up a little bit, and then you can get your running game going.
After the incompletion, second down and 10. Two backs with Bluford. Handing off to Donald Babers. Picks up about 3. A year ago, Prairie View averaged 4.5 yards per rushing attempt. In the first half, 2 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that kind of shows you where this Texas Southern program is trying to go. I mean, some of these big guys up front, you have, you know, Rolando Melanson and Shamari Clemens, the linebacker. I mean, these guys have been playing extremely well.
Third down and 7. Prairie View has only converted twice on third down tonight.
Bringing pressure.
Fumble, loose football. Tigers think they have it.
That was the blitz up the middle by the linebacker. Got a sack on that in the first half, and now they have the football. Same blitz coming up the middle. Number 44, the linebacker, DeJuan Falgum. The back tried to get the block, and he couldn't get there in time. And just great pressure from the outside and also the linebacker coming up the middle. That blitz was able to sack the quarterback in the first half. And, of course, a good defensive coordinator like Kevin Ramsey, if you don't stop it, I'm going to keep calling it.
Either Andrew Sugg or Justin Coleman recovered that fumble caused by Fulgham. First down for the Tigers. Pass is dropped. William Osborne, the intended receiver. So the second turnover by Prairie View A&M tonight, the first one resulted directly in 7 points for the Tigers, and now Texas Southern still looking for their first points from the offense.
Yeah, they've been having some success offensively. A couple of things are working. They're moving up and down the football field. I think they play better when they're in this spread offense.
Bad snap. Nelson trying to set up the screen and throws it right to Johnny Cole. Good catch.
We thought he played quarterback in college. Maybe he was a wideout also. You know, he calls his own plays. Not too many head coaches actually calls the plays. But hey, Johnny is one of those guys. He grew up as an offensive coordinator through the coaching ranks, and everywhere he's been, he's put a lot of points on the board as an offensive coordinator. And I don't think that's something he wants to give to any assistant. He wants to have control of that himself.
You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime from Reliant Stadium. Texas Southern versus Prairie View A&M. Carter Blackburn alongside former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr. Awaiting third down and 10 for Texas Southern. Nelson flushed out, has to dump it down to Warren. Stretching it, he gets the first down inside the 25.
Good decision by Arvell Nelson. Hey, by the time I get out the pocket, just dump it off to Warren, let him run and do the dirty work and get the first down. Very efficient quarterback play by Arvell Nelson, not making the mistakes. And that's what you need, first of all, by your quarterback. Don't lose the football game.
High backfield on first down from the 25. Marcus Wright shoved back after a gain of a couple, the sophomore from Dayton, Ohio.
I tell you, Texas Southern has a group of two very good young water running backs, and sophomore Joseph Warren from right here locally at Madison High School, and also Marcus Wright, another sophomore. I mean, both of these guys together are going to have a pretty good running attack with that big offensive line, couple of transfers, and Matt Hardick and Alex Williams. But those guys, I mean, they're going to be able to run the football, and you add that with all of the passing that Johnny Cole likes to do, good offense.
Wright takes the toss on second down, and he is met in the backfield by Chris Ford, the strong side linebacker. First-year starter Chris Ford from Westbury High School here in Houston.
Yeah, good discipline play. This is that little fake to the fullback and the pitch to the tailback. That play got popular with Marshall Faulk and all that stuff on turf, and that thing was hard to stop. Now, even the colleges know how to stop it, but it's still a good discipline play. I mean, if you're chasing that fullback, that play can go for big yards. So give Chris Ford credit for doing his job and then making the tackle.
Third down and 12 for Texas Southern. Empty backfield. Over the middle, batted, almost intercepted. Intended for the tight end, Hannah. And Anthony Beck, who has 8 interceptions in his career, nearly got number 9.
I tell you what, this is a play that Jonathan Hannah has got to make. He made this play in the end of the second half for a first down. He just took his eyes off of the football and started to try to run a little too fast. That was a good throw, once again, by quarterback Arvell Nelson, and Beck had the opportunity to make their interception and keep points off the board, but just couldn't get it done.
Hirsch on to attempt a 44-yard field goal. He missed from 32 at the end of the half. And he misses from 44. So a Prairie View A&M turnover leads to no points from Texas Southern, and we remain tied 7-all in the Labor Day Classic. Welcome back to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by Citi as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. The 25th annual Labor Day Classic in Houston, matching Texas Southern and Prairie View A&M. Both scores occurred in the fourth quarter, and with this 44-yard miss, no scoring since, and we're still even at 7.
Then he ended the second quarter missing the field goal, and then you have another attempt, so I think at this point, Johnny Cole, I'm sure, feels like he should be up at least 3 points in this football game. However, it's still a 7-7 tie.
Prairie View A&M had the big fourth down conversion late in the first quarter, and then the touchdown grab by Osazi Edei. But the offense has run stagnant since then, in part because they can't get this ground game going. Babers picks up 3 there.
And this big offensive line from Prairie View, they've been together for the last couple of years. I mean, all of these guys were redshirted, so it's a bunch of redshirt sophomores and juniors. You know, Stoney Owens, James Delkley, Tim Tussey. So this guy, these players have been together for the last couple of years. They expect to be able to run the football well.
Deagle, the left guard, preseason All-SWAC. Second down and 7. Bluford. Batted away. What a play by Anthony Webb, knocking it free from Osazi Edion.
Yeah, that matchup has been the best that I've seen in a couple of years here. I mean, Osazi Edion and Anthony Webb are going back and forth. Of course, Edion has the one touchdown conversion. He missed a long ball. I think Webb got away with a pull on the jersey earlier. Now he comes back and makes a very good play. So these guys are going at it.
Forcing third down and 7. Prairie View going with more of a hurry up now. Signals in for the senior QB Bluford, first year as a starter. Rolling on third and 7 to the sideline, and it's incomplete, intended for Sean Stevens. So another 3-and-out for Prairie View, and here you are 4 minutes into the third quarter, and the Panthers still don't have 100 yards of offense, only 73 at the break. And to start the second half, a fumble and now a 3-and-out.
Yeah, and you have to give a lot of credit for the defensive coordinator, Kevin Ramsey, for TSU. I mean, this guy has been at a lot of different places, the University of Georgia with the Arizona Cardinals. And this is his first year at Texas Southern. He really has his defense playing at a high level and taking away what Prairie View likes to do.
Pedro Ventura punts it away. Webb backs up, tries to Willie Mays it. Returns it to the 24. Good punt from Ventura. Frazier had a great line about Pedro Ventura, the punter. He says he's Tiger Woods with a football. He can just put it anywhere. Yeah, so I guess that was more like the 4-iron out of the bag for Ventura.
Well, that's to keep the ball away from Will Osborne punt. That's what that is. What they're trying to do is make sure that William Osborne doesn't have a chance to touch that ball on punt returns. And that's the main thing you want to do. Hey, let's not have a big play happen against us.
Change at QB for Texas Southern. Gino Simone, the transfer from College of the Sequoias, is in. First action for him in relief of Arvell Nelson, trying to get a spark for a Tiger offense, which hasn't scored tonight. Handing on first down. Warren, the ball carrier. Century makes the stop. Simone, the sophomore from Clovis, California, the Fresno area, went to Buchanan High School. Again, he and Nelson were locked in a QB battle. Nelson got the nod. He was not here for spring ball. Simone was. Nelson was.
And Coach Cole, he told us that we would see Simone and Nelson both play in this game today.
Simone looks to be changing the play before second down and 8 with the play clock winding down. On snap, fumble, Prairie View recovers.
And that play never had a chance. I think he was rushing because the play clock was starting to run down. He was never really set at the quarterback position. You get a bad snap, a 360 spin around and handoff here. Take a look at it. You're rushing. The snap goes around, and hey, the running back never had a chance. A great opportunity for Prairie View to make a big play. Ronaldo Revelta is Johnny on the spot with the fumble recovery. But I think that's more of a mistake by the Tigers than anything great by Prairie View.
So on the second play, that Simone quarterbacks Texas Southern. It's the first turnover of the night for the Tigers. Ronaldo Revolta, part of a great Prairie View A&M family, with a fumble recovery. Bluford and the Panther offense looking to cash in from inside the 25. Babers cuts it back, looking for a block. He doesn't get it. Dragged down with John Demps in pursuit the whole way.
Yeah, I tell you what, this Texas Southern University defense has been playing extremely well. You talk about John Demps. We looked at him yesterday. Looked just like the guy I used to play with at University of Florida, Javon Kirsch. And look at those long arms. I mean, he can run you down. And Babers is a fast guy, 1,000-yard rusher. He's going to be an impact player for the defense this year.
On second down, Bluford completing. to Alonzo Revolta.
Yeah, I tell you what, the Revolta boys are getting involved. Of course, you have Alonzo Revolta, who is a redshirt freshman at tight end. His brother, 55, Ronaldo, just had the fumble recovery, and they have an older brother who's a GA. And their mom and dad went to Prairie View, so they keep it in the family. They're Panthers through and through.
Father Arnold also coached at Prairie View in the 80s. This is third down and one for the Panthers. To the end zone. There's the flag. Osazi Edei, the intended receiver.
I just love it when two players have a one-on-one battle going on within the football game. That's what you see here. I mean, Osazi Edei and Anthony Webb, they're doing their own thing. These guys are going at it like, you know, playing in the back parking lot. Hey, you, your turn, my turn. Both of them have had some big plays. One has a touchdown, a couple pass breakups, and now we have a call by the referee here. We don't know who is on, but, man, these guys are going at it. They're both very good players.
Holding on the defense, number 12. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Webb, the sophomore from Dallas, Texas. I think I said earlier a freshman. He's, in fact, a sophomore from Dallas. Doing battle with the big senior, Gabe Osazi Edei.
Yeah, he's not backing down. I mean, he's going play for play. He's not asking the coach for help. Hey, I got him one-on-one, so we'll see what happens. They may go at him again.
First and goal. Babers maybe gets a yard for DeJuan Fulgham. Middle linebacker, preseason all-SWAC player, drags him down.
This TSU defense is up for the task. I mean, they put in the power back 34, Michael Jason. He tries to go up the middle, they stop him. They put in the fast back Babers. He tries to go around the corner, and they run him down. I mean, this TSU defense playing very aggressive against the run. I like what I see out of them this year.
Tiger defense trying to again give this team a lift after the offense turned it over for the first time tonight. Second and goal. Babers again.
Nothing doing. Once again, we have DeJuan Fulgham on the tackle. He led this team in tackles at over 100 last year, and he has to be at least close to the double digits today. And Babers, guy that had 1,000 yards rushing last year, only 16 yards, averaging 1.5 yards per carry. He's a big play guy, but just can't get it going tonight.
After a 1,000-yard rushing season last year. Third down and goal. Luford tries the hard count and now looking back to the sideline for a change in plays. Luford pressured and sacked.
Say, but I cringed when I saw that coming. That was a big hit. It's a linebacker. That's what you want. Look at DeJuan Fulgham. That same blitz right up the middle. He had a sack earlier. He caused a fumble off this blitz, and now he's coming again clean right up that gap between the center and the guard. And I tell you what, if they don't stop that play, he'll get a couple more big plays like that, because Kevin Ramsey is going to keep calling that same blitz until Prairie View can make the adjustment.
Panthers bring out the kicking unit. Brady Faggard, 31-yard attempt. No good. Flag on the play, though.
Offside, defense number 7. Replay, fourth down.
That hurts. You Texas Southern, that hurts. I mean, you stopped them. I mean, you kind of weathered the storm. They missed the field goal. I mean, a good field goal kicker, he misses the field goal, then you line up offside. Man, you can't have that.
It's Robert Joseph. So Prairie View got to first and goal with a pass interference call against Webb. And now after a missed 31-yarder, another chance for Brady Faggard and the Panthers.
And you look at Johnny Cole on the sideline as a coach that just kind of kills you inside when your team is giving another team second chances. Hey, if you're going to beat us on the football field, beat us, but we can't just give you second chances.
Now it's a 26-yard attempt for Faggard. This time it's good, and Prairie View A&M makes the most of its second chance to take a 10-7 lead. Critical penalty for Texas Southern.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
A 10-7 lead now for Prairie View A&M on Texas Southern. Under 7 to go in the third. ESPNU's Campus Connection is your window. What's happening at the universities we visit every week. Our man Daniel Sampson is back for a quick look at Texas Southern's marching ocean of soul.
Best band in the SWAC. That being Texas Southern Band, that is the ocean of the soul of the ocean. And it's a lot of excitement. You need to be there. It's going on. You know, we're going in, y'all.
Okay, we got the battle of the bands going on tonight. Prairie View versus TSU. Who's going to have the better band? Hey, you already know what I say, man. TSU all the way.
The band brings us the most.
The drum section, man. Of course.
Yes, you, we love you.
Thanks again to Daniel Sampson. There's the ocean of soul. So, Eddie, who do you take in the battle of the bands from halftime here?
I tell you what, both fans did an extremely good job. I would have to call it a tie. I almost like this football game.
Wow.
I would have to call it a tie. I mean, they both were fantastic. And in Prairie View, you could just tell, I mean, their band is much bigger than I've ever seen. And I think that kind of coincides with the whole football program turning around.
Short kickoff. Loose ball. Goes out of bounds, which means that Texas Southern keeps it. But they go for the pooch kick. They bring on Pedro Ventura for the pooch kick and nearly got the result they wanted with a fumble on the kickoff. But it has been a lot of penalties and now points off turnovers, the critical numbers in this ballgame.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the penalties is something that you have to control. But of course, Texas Southern, their interception in the return for the touchdown, and Prairie View with the benefit of the turnover and then the penalty got the second chance at the field goal with their 3 points off the turnovers.
Gino Simone back out to quarterback Texas Southern. Handing off to the junior Martin Gilbert out of the backfield. The last Texas Southern possession was the fumble recovered by Revolta that ends up in the go-ahead field goal by the Panthers.
And Texas Southern has been the team that's had more success running the football. I mean, that's something that's pretty impressive against this tough Prairie View defense. They're able to get a couple yards in the run game.
Second and short to the ground again. Ford comes up to stick Gilbert. Log on to Facebook today. Search ESPNU and become a fan. Post your best tailgating photos and comments. We may use them on Inside the Polls Monday at 6 o'clock on ESPNU HD.
So I told you I have 75 unaccepted friends on Facebook, but if you know, if you put a friend request, I'll accept you, Carter.
Thanks, man. I appreciate
right.
it. I'm going to post the tailgating photos earlier. Penalty flag on third down. Simone throwing over the middle. Incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Curtin. Let's see what the flag is.
Can't give up first downs off of penalties. They run the play, you stop them. You should be in the punt situation if you're Prairie View, but man, once again, the penalties has hurt both of these teams. Actually gave Prairie View the 3-point lead. But that's something that these coaches are really going to have to tighten up on before they play another game next week.
Another opportunity for the Tigers. Quick drop for Simone. Swings it to Dixon in the flat. Nice open field tackle.
You
Dixon is a big kid. He's a wide receiver, goes 6'2", 210, a junior. Transfer from LSU. He's a possession receiver. They like his size. They like the way he can, you know, manhandle and get himself in a good position. But you also have to try to make that guy miss. Good open field tackle by Prairie View in that situation.
It was Lester Butler, the corner, on the tackle, making it second down and eight. Osborne gets it on the screen. Tries to spin away, but again, Lester Butler getting help this time from Chris Ford with open field tackling.
Yeah, I really like this play because you have a guy that has 2,300 all-purpose yards and you get him in the football with a one-on-one matchup and see if he can make someone miss. That's a great job by Lester Butler standing up and squaring up one of the most dangerous runners in the conference.
Third down again for the Tigers. Simone has the ball batted and incomplete. Somebody got a hand on it up close.
Yeah, just can't get a passing lane. That's a great job. Looks like Quentin Spears coming back in there. This guy was 5 sacks last year, all conference performer, big time pass rusher, was able to get a hand on that football, forced a fourth down play.
It was Spears who had the offsides, giving Texas Southern a second chance, but he makes up for it. Batting down that third down pass. This will be Solomon punting it to Anthony Wheaton. Fair catch called for. It bounces and takes a very good roll for Texas Southern down to the 16. Panthers get the football back with a three-point edge.
Years of culture and tradition have passed through the hands of those before us. It is now our duty to honor the heritage given to us and uphold it for those next in line.
We on top, never underrated. We on top, never underrated.
We will take the field and we will be tomorrow's legends. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
On the last Prairie View A&M possession, a 26-yard field goal to give the Panthers a three-point edge on Texas Southern. ESPNU's coverage of college football continues Thursday. Florida A&M facing Winston-Salem State. College football primetime on ESPNU and ESPNU HD Thursday, 7:30 Eastern. For more, log on to ESPNU.com. First down and 10 for Prairie View A&M. Jay Bluford from the shotgun, handing off to Donald Babers, a 1,000-yard rusher a season ago. Held in check thus far by Texas Southern. He's able to pick up four on first down.
Yeah, but I tell you what, now that Prairie View does have a three-point lead, look for Coach Frazier to be very patient with his offensive play call. He's still going to run that football, work the clock, maybe take a big shot deep to Gable Sazi-Adiai, which has kind of paid off early on, but trust me, they're going to let their defense try to win this football game and just keep being patient on offense.
Flags before.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense number 70. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So it will be second down and 11 now for Prairie View A&M. That field goal by Faggard, the first scoring in this game since the first quarter. There was the touchdown grab by Eddie I. There was the interception for a touchdown from DeMarcus Washington. And a low scoring Labor Day Classic. Pressure on second down. Bluford gets rid of it, completing the pass to Stevens. Clemens makes the tackle from behind. Otherwise, Stevens may have had some running room.
Good job by Buford stepping up and making a good throw. Man, I think he's really settled down as a quarterback. He threw that first interception return for a touchdown. And as a coach, you have to wonder, okay, where's this kid's head? Is he going to respond? Is he going to recover? But the guy's a senior. He's been here the last couple years, and he did a great job of settling down as Like once again, seems like we have another false start on Prairie View.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense number 75. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Can't like that if you're the coach, because now you're in the first and 15. Of course, this is a run first team, and they're just not really well equipped to convert these long situations. Unnecessary penalties that really hurt both of these football teams.
Four wide, Babers joining Bluford in the backfield for first and 15. Clock winding down. They just do get it off. Bluford has to tuck it. And he has dropped for a loss. DeJuan Fulgham again bringing pressure.
Yeah, Fulgham has been everywhere. Number 44, the middle linebacker, has been playing well. Cole, number 53, pressure from the outside.
Under 2 minutes remaining in the third. Second down and long coming up for Prairie View A&M. Play clock again winding down. Bluford, quick throw to the sideline. Complete to Stevens. Out of bounds at the 30, about 9 yards short of the first down.
And Bluford's having a lot more success throwing those short, quick passes. When he has to stand in the pocket and look downfield, I mean, it's just too much pass rush by Texas Southern. When he's able to take those three-step drop, get the ball out of his hand fast, and let the receivers make something happen, that's when his passing game for Prairie View has been the most effective.
Call this third down and 8. More pressure up the middle. Bluford gets back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it.
Yeah, good tough man coverage down the field. They feel like they can cover these receivers one-on-one. And they're letting the pass rushers do their thing. Michael Shelton getting a big sack on that play. But it's pretty much been coming from everywhere. I mean, they're blitzing a lot on third down, and this defense for Texas Southern has really been up to the task. Only giving up 10 points, and they scored 7 themselves. So they're playing great football defensively, the TSU Tigers.
Pedro Ventura will punt for Prairie View A&M, trying to keep it away from William Osborne. Another successful punt. Webb fields it. Webb crossing midfield to the 48, setting up the Texas Southern offense. ...22-yard return there for Webb. Not bad for your number two return man when they're keeping it away from William Osborne.
Yeah, he's going to get a lot of return attempts because you don't want to kick it to Will Osborne, but that's an opportunity for him. So you know if they're going to try to keep the ball out of Will Osborne's hand, you're going to get some bad kicks, some shanks because they're doing different things. Hey, step up, make some big plays, and take advantage of the opportunity. That's what he's been doing tonight.
Simone back in at quarterback, under center on first down. Hand off to Marcus Wright. Breaks the first tackle, and then Anthony Beck, the safety, after a gain of 9.
And Anthony Beck, he's made a lot of shoestring tackles because guys are coming at him full speed through those holes. And the safety, Anthony Beck, has been making some good plays.
One.
Welcome back to the 25th annual Labor Day Classic, a 10-7 Prairie View A&M lead on Texas Southern as we head to the fourth quarter. Carter Blackburn with Eddie Robinson Jr. Pleased to be joined by Pro Football Hall of Famer Eric Dickerson, native of the Houston area, Sealy, Texas. So you showed up to be a special guest of honor at the Labor Day Classic.
Yes, and I'm glad I showed up. Great game. I love to watch the bands and everything, and just glad to be here. Never been in the Lions Stadium before. Never had a chance to play here.
You were next door at the Astrodome during the play.
You got it. Those were the old days back in the Astrodome with the bad turf and everything.
Well, you did all right running on. Of course, Eric, sixth all-time on the NFL's all-time rushing list. You know, this is not only about these two universities, but this is a game that's kind of about football in the city of Houston. You're from this area. What does football mean to the city of Houston in this area?
Well, I mean, when you think about football, you think about Texas and honestly. I mean, I think about Texas and I think about the Houston area because I grew up down here, right down in Sealy. And football is big down here. If it's college football, if it's high school football, even if it's junior high football, people love that sport. I mean, it's all about football.
Yeah, I tell you what, I mean, I went to a high school football game last night. And like you said, I live here in Houston locally, and it's just real big. I started off playing with the Oilers. Of course, I missed your career, so I'm glad I didn't have a chance to try to stop you.
Well, honestly, I went to a high school football game, too. I went to watch my high school football team. I went down to watch Sealy and Hempstead play last night. And it's always good to come back and watch high school football. It's always good to come back to Texas. Even though I live in Los Angeles, I'm still a Texan at heart.
I tell you what, who do you think in the NFL now most reminds you of yourself? I think Adrian Peterson is the guy that, you know, seems to be like the new Eric Dickerson, if there could ever be a new Eric Dickerson.
Most definitely Adrian Peterson. I mean, he's big, he's fast. I mean, he's that guy that can really dominate a football game. And, you know, I look at him, and I met Adrian when he first came out, and he asked me, what should I know when I try to play, Eric? You know, what is things I should look for? I said, just go out and don't let them intimidate you. And I think when I look at the game, he's doing the intimidating right now.
Yeah, he runs with an attitude.
Right, a bad attitude.
Right. And you like that from a running back with that size and speed, eh? I think he may be the next Eric Dickerson.
I mean, I would say he's most definitely the next Eric Dickerson.
Absolutely.
Fumble on the first play of the fourth quarter. Century recovers, so that means it's first down and 10 for Prairie View A&M. And a golden opportunity here for the Panthers with a 10-7 lead start of the fourth quarter. Bluford from the shotgun with three wide on first and 10. Setting up the screen to Babers. Spinning near midfield, big hit. You know, Eric, this reminds me of all the hits that you took during the playing games and the pro day. No, I'm not going to say this. How did you stay healthy? How did you play so long when as a running back, you're taking hits like this?
You know, by the grace of God, I stayed healthy. And, you know, when I looked at that run right there, and the best thing he did was got his feet off the ground. That's what keeps you healthy, because you're standing around piles and guys are falling on you. That's when you get hurt.
What did you call your running style? Everyone talks about you, kind of the straight-up running style, and obviously with great success. What did you call it?
It was just how I ran. I mean, I ran like that in high school and college, and it worked for me. One thing is that people always said I wouldn't last long because I ran too straight up. But the thing is, it's not true. I ran straight up only when I got an open field. That was it.
Well, I tell you what, I mean, you've played, had a great Hall of Fame career. So what is Eric Dickerson doing right now? I mean, I know you're staying busy.
Playing a lot of golf.
Okay.
Playing a lot of golf. I just came back from Costa Rica, and I came through Texas to my house in Texas. I just do a lot of appearances and play a lot of golf and do a lot of traveling. I thank God, you know, I can honestly say football was good to me.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a great way to make a living. I always tell kids that, hey, there's no reason not to aspire to make it to the NFL.
No, I mean, it's a great way to make a living, but understand one thing. That is a job, and it is a tough living, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Third down for Prairie View A&M. Bluford to the air, just off the hands of the intended receiver, Whedon, with Robert Joseph in coverage. Now, I want to get back to Sealy. Every time you drive down I-10, the Sealy Tigers, there used to be a billboard with Eric Dickerson right there. I want to know what happened to the billboard,
man,
and what happened to the football game last night.
Well, they won the game, I think it was 41-7. I left in the third quarter. It was 31-0 at half, so that game was over right quick. That billboard, they didn't take care of the billboard. I mean, they did the right thing. Cut it down. If they'd have asked me to put some, I'd have got up there and put some paint on that billboard.
Right,
it looked
right.
So bad.
Fourth and three now is Texas Southern once again comes up with a defensive stop. Osborne finally gets a touch, but it's inside the five. Trying to dance his way into open field. Penalty flag coming up as Osborne's dropped near the four.
Now, Eric, what do you follow now? You watch more college football or NFL football? What sport did you really get into?
Probably not gonna like this. I don't watch football.
Oh, really?
No, I don't watch it. I mean, honestly, that was a job for me, and I don't watch football. I don't like watching it. You know, I'll watch a little bit of it. I just can't watch a lot of it.
Back, number 13 of the receiving team. Penalty will be enforced half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down, Texas Southern.
Tigers backed up all the way to the two. Now, your alma mater, SMU, New head coach June Jones now in his second year. Have you followed Coach Jones'
most
efforts
definitely.
To try and rebuild that SMU program?
Most definitely. You know, I've talked to Coach Jones about the program. I've made some calls for him, you know, for some of the recruits they've called me. And, you know, I'm looking forward to SMU getting back on the track, you know, that we once had, that great tradition we had down at SMU. And I think he'll do a great job of it.
That was in the heyday of the Southwest Conference,
too. Oh, man, that was the heyday, you said, of the Southwest Conference. And, you know, the Southwest Conference is no more.
Nelson back to QB, throwing to Osborne on first down. It's incomplete.
I tell you, you talked about Texas football as you first came on. I mean, with that pony express, you think there would be two running backs like that again that can play in the same backfield at the same time?
No.
Can't happen again.
No.
But give me your honest answer.
No, you got to give me my honest opinion. No. I don't think so. I mean, honestly, you know, I didn't think that would work at the time. And I don't think Craig thought it would work at the time. But, you know, it really worked good for both of us. And I know for a fact it made my career long in the NFL. And it made his career long in the NFL also.
Well, you say now, I mean, all of the teams now are going with the two running back system. Very seldom you see one guy that can just carry the load like an Earl Campbell or Eric Dickerson and be the guy for an NFL football team for 16 weeks.
Well, really, that is happening, but because they can't find that guy. I mean, it's hard to find a guy that can be that workhorse. And you see Minnesota has that guy in Adrian Peterson. And you have other guys that can come in and play, but every team would like to have that workhorse. I mean, it's like every team wants to have that quarterback they can count on in all situations. Or that linebacker, or that punter. I mean, but it's hard to find that guy that you can count on every down.
So you mean there's not another Eric Dickerson walking around in Texas somewhere that we can plug in and be that guy again?
Oh,
it's only
sure.
One of you.
It's one coming through the pipes. I mean, for sure right now, Adrian Peterson is that guy. I mean, I give him his props. He's that guy. It's another one coming up for sure.
This is third down and 10 for Arbell Nelson, and the Tigers backed up from their own two, and they may not have gotten this one off. So flag half the distance to the goal, which is only about a yard.
Delay of game, offense, half the distance to the goal, still third down.
The chain gang doesn't have to move far to reset for third down. Call it third down and 11 from the one. Nelson has to get rid of it. It's incomplete as he was pressured trying to avoid the safety. Throws it incomplete. Prairie View A&M comes up with a stop.
Tell you what, Carter, that Prairie View defense is really getting into this football game. And hey, Texas Southern can't get anything going in the second half.
Well, Eric, thank you very much for stopping by the booth.
Thank you guys for having me, and good luck to the rest of the season.
All right, man.
Okay.
Hey, watch a little bit more college football. What about that?
I'll try to watch a little more college football.
All right, there you go.
Okay,
Pro Football Hall of Famer Eric Dickerson, special guest of honor here at the 25th annual Labor Day Classic, the native of Sealy, Texas, and, of course, great college career at SMU up the road in Dallas, Texas. Big chance for a special teams play here as Anthony Wheaton returns the punt inside the 20. So the Panther defense forces the punt. Wheaton breaks the big special teams play.
Hey, whenever you see that line drive kick with that punter backed up in the end zone, you always know that returner has a good chance to go right up the pipe just like Wheaton did. Prairie View A&M is in position to make something big happen right now.
After the 22-yard return by Wheaton, the Panthers get it at the 15, leading by 3. ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by City. City never sleeps. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime SWAC Conference Football presented by City as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week at Reliant Stadium in Houston. Prairie View A&M leading Texas Southern 10-7. A punt return to the 15 sets up the Panthers.
Yeah, and once again, this Texas Southern defense coming on the field with a short field. They're going to have to really step up and make a big play. They've been up to the task all night, but they have to do it again right now.
Bluford handing off on first down. Babers stood up and driven back. Shamari Clemens makes the tackle. And that's a good start for the Texas Southern defense as they have all night.
Yeah, Shamari Clemens, number 17, 44, DeJuan Fogelman. And these linebackers are playing extremely well. 42, John Dempsey. We've been calling their name all night. I mean, this Prairie View offense, I mean, they've pretty much
run roughshod over everybody they've played last year running the football. They're big and they're physical, but tonight, Texas Southern is having none of that.
Timeout Prairie View prior to second down. And remember, strategy-wise here for Prairie View A&M, they have a missed 31-yard field goal earlier from Brady Faggard. He then hit a 26-yarder.
I think they're thinking touchdown right now. They know if they can get a touchdown the way their defense is playing, I think that they feel very good about their chances of winning this football game.
Monday evening, catch two college football shows on ESPNU. First 5 Eastern Crunch Time will deliver the entire closing minutes and moments of all the significant and close college football contests from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, host Lowell Galindo. Analyst Tom Luganville and Tommy Tuberville dissect and analyze the new polls and preview the next week's matchups on Inside the Polls, presented by 76. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. And no doubt both of those shows will feature the BYU-Oklahoma finish, and the polls are going to be shaken up early on in the 2009 college football season.
Well, you know, every year there's at least one upset opening week, whether it was the Michigan-App State game a couple years ago. It's always someone that's not going to do as good as everyone thought. And I don't know, that's a big game, big upset, big win for BYU.
Second down. Screen incomplete. Intended for Babers. And Ohio State nearly upset today by Navy. And Iowa got a scare from Northern Iowa.
Yeah.
Actually, Big Ten with the OT as well, and Syracuse too, with Minnesota and the Orange.
Yeah, Syracuse, your alma mater. I'm sure you've watched that game pretty tightly today.
Solid debut for the Orange. Of course, Greg Paulus.
So you like what you see so far?
They played hard, which is a welcome return to the days when Keith Bullock and Dwight Freeney were flying around the football.
Yep.
Bucky Jones, Donovan Darius, the heyday.
I tell you, know those guys well. Must have been some classmates or something.
I went to class.
Third down here for Jay Bluford.
Pumps to the end zone. Caught for a touchdown.
Nice.
Brandon Bell with his first career touchdown grab.
I tell you what, great pump fake by Jay Buford. He's playing like a senior. This may be his first career start, but Brandon Bell with the catch. That's just a great route. You beat the wide receiver, make the easy catch. Prairie View takes a big lead in this football game.
Baggard for the PAT. It is good. And a 10-point lead for Prairie View A&M. Brandon Bell, the junior from Pompano Beach, Florida, with the touchdown grab. And the Panthers strike first in the fourth.
Healthcare alert. Daily registration limits have been established for all Americans seeking affordable access to healthcare. Register now for immediate acceptance. If you are among the millions of Americans not routinely visiting healthcare providers because you are concerned with the soaring cost of healthcare, you are putting your health at risk. Don't let the high cost of healthcare prevent you and your family from having access to quality doctors, hospitals, labs, and pharmacies at discounted rates when you need them. Announcing open registration for an affordable national healthcare discount program. Call now and learn about your 30-day trial for this nationwide healthcare discount program. You will be able to save 20 to 60% on doctors, hospitals, labs, prescription drugs, and more. Don't put this off. We will only accept 650 new registrations a day for 2009.
Call 800-696-8103 and start saving on your family's healthcare needs. That's 800-696-8103.
Years of culture and tradition have passed through the hands of those before us. It is now our duty to honor the heritage given to us and uphold it for those next in line.
We on top, never underrated. We on top, never underrated.
We will take the field, and we will be tomorrow's legends. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. If your child was born with cerebral palsy or Erb's palsy, it may have been due to medical mistakes or exposure to chemicals during pregnancy. Caring for a disabled child can be financially and emotionally challenging. Call now as you may be entitled to compensation. Again, if your child was born with cerebral palsy, Erb's palsy, or any other serious birth injury, call 1-800-801-1664. That's 1-800-801-1664. Call now.
Maya, like many people, has too much credit card debt. How about you? Do you have $5, $10, $15, or even $25,000 or more in credit card debt? I'm Todd Cook, founder of 800 Credit Card Debt. We'll help you find a payoff plan you can live with, one that could work with your creditors to eliminate penalties, lower your interest rates, and even reduce what you owe. Call us, because you can pay off your credit cards and still have money left over each month.
Call 1-800-827-0135.
They've been playing since the 1940s. Texas Southern has dominated the series with Prairie View A&M, and this is their 64th meeting. But in recent years, the Panthers have turned that tide. They have won four of the last five meetings with Texas Southern, including the last two. And now the Panthers with a 10-point lead for Henry Frazier, the third's team in the fourth quarter. And the Tigers have not scored a point on offense today. The only scoring came from the defense. And now with just over 12 minutes remaining in the ballgame, their offense is going to have to score at least twice.
And they've been productive between the 30s, but they just can't get it into the end zone.
Coach kick rolls inside the 20 and will roll out of bounds. So a good field position start for Texas Southern. After the penalty, now the Tigers can't elect to have Prairie View A&M re-kick this. ESPNU's coverage of college football continues on Thursday as the Florida A&M Rattlers face Winston-Salem State. College football primetime on ESPNU and ESPNU HD Thursday, 7:30 Eastern. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. And sure enough, Johnny Cole is going to take the option of the re-kick. That's a recent change in college football last couple of years. Rather than just taking the penalty and the field position, you can re-kick. So with the dangerous William Osborne in the kicking game, Texas Southern hoping somehow, some way that he gets his hands on the football with a chance for a return.
Yeah, and that's going to be the challenge this year for the special teams coach. They have to figure out a way to move him around, switch sides, so he can get his hands on the football, because I mean, any smart coach is not going to kick the ball to him if you have a chance to avoid him.
Osborne and Webb do switch positions, hoping to confuse Prairie View A&M. Ventura kicks it right down the middle. Good kick fielded by Webb near the five. They've taken it away from Osborne. Slips, cuts it back. Webb pushes it forward to the 32. 27-yard return.
Now look at this Texas Southern's offense. I mean, they've had their chances today. And they've had some good plays from the running game, some good plays from the passing game, but they haven't been able to put everything together on one drive and consistently move down the field and get into the end zone. A lot to build on. We'll see if they can make some big plays in this drive to get back into this football game.
Nelson was the QB last time out. Gino Simone, the sophomore transfer from College of the Sequoias in California, back in. Play fake on first down. Simone pressured and sacked. Max Century is the man who got to him.
Yeah, he's just got a little bit too comfortable in the pocket. When you miss that first guy as a quarterback, you better throw it, because the second one's going to get you. In Century, he just comes right up the pipe. The pressure from the outside coming by number 14, Chris Ford. But then Century gets the sack. And Prairie View putting some pressure on the Texas Southern Tigers.
And now a flag on Texas Southern.
the offense, 12 men on the field, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So call it second down and 21 now after the sack and the penalty. The Tigers are headed in the wrong direction on a critical drive in the fourth.
Good time to try a screen play or something to try to trick the defense.
Here comes the screen. It's to the tight end, Hannah. Rumbles downfield for about a 7-yard gain. University of North Carolina transfer, Jonathan Hanna.
Yeah, Hanna's a big one. He had a couple catches early in the first half, had a couple big plays, and that's someone that they're going to really try to feature this year, work that tight end into the offense. Always hard when you have a big tight end. Defense is never really key on those guys.
Huge third down. Simone throws over the middle, incomplete for Joe Anderson. Punting unit comes out for Texas Southern.
You can tell the experience of this Prairie View defense. These guys have been together for a number of years. A lot of these coaches came down to Prairie View with Coach Frazier. I mean, a lot of them have been here all 6 years. So when you have that continuity on your coaching staff, these guys have been through some tough times. They've really kind of melded together as one big team and one big family. You can tell that experience is really paying off as this game goes down the stretch.
Solomon gets a good kick away, forcing Wheaton to call for the fair catch, and he somehow hangs on to the football.
I mean, we were inside, but maybe there was a sudden breeze that blew that ball left to right because it seemed like he lost it at the last minute. I don't know.
Roof is closed tonight at Reliant, so no wind factor.
I think he got away with one there. You know, last year with that big hurricane that came through here, that roof was actually blown off. Well, fortunately, it was damaged and they couldn't close it, so you had to have outside football in Texas. Of course, the fans don't really like that. They don't like when it gets too hot down here, you know, playing outside.
I mean, next door's the place that pioneered indoor.
I like the Astrodome. That's where I grew up playing back in 92 with Warren Boone and that run and shoot offense.
Michael Jason gets the first down carry for Prairie View A&M, shoved out at the 36.
Look for Prairie View to give Texas Southern a heavy dose of that run game. Even though it hasn't been effective early in the football game, you think as a coach you can wear the defense down. Now that you have a lead going into the fourth quarter, you want to try to run that ball now and see if that defense is still up to the task of making those tackles and those plays they were making early on.
This is second down and three. Jason gets it again. Michael Jason tries to bounce it outside. Second effort, he gets near the first down. Demps makes the tackle. The sophomore from Booker T. Washington High School here in Houston, Texas, picks up the first down. His biggest game of 2008 was in the Labor Day Classic at 78 rushing yards. Coach Frazier and the Panthers expect big things out of Jason in his sophomore year.
Yeah, I mean, he's a hard running back. I mean, he's not wearing 34 by accident. Coach Frazier gave him number 34. And in Texas, there's only one 34. Of course, that's Earl Campbell. And he feels like this guy can be that type of player.
Fake it to Jason Bluford. Tries to take it outside. Curtis Thomas there to greet him. You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime at Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas, home of the Houston Texans and home of the Labor Day Classic, Texas Southern University and the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. I'm Carter Blackburn alongside former Alabama State and NFL linebacker Eddie Robinson Jr.
You know, we talked to Coach Cole yesterday, and there's a lot of good things going on campus. I mean, they're playing this big game here at Reliant, but they still play on campus, but they're actually going to have a joint venture with the Dynamos and have a stadium downtown, which would be great for this program. Be a light rail that will actually take you from the Texas Southern campus to the stadium, and I think that's going to be a real big deal as far as recruiting and just the overall atmosphere to get your fans into the game.
You see Bluford down on the field getting stretched out, so both teams to the sideline. That stadium on the east side of downtown will be right by where the Astros play at Minute Maid Park, and scheduled to open in 2011. And Coach Cole has very high hopes for this Texas Southern program. He says, I don't think there's any reason why we can't be like the University of Miami, where we're in a football-rich environment. If we can get young men to stay in the city of Houston and play football for Texas Southern University, we can build something special here.
And the thing about it is he's played here. He's been through this. You know, he wore the TSU helmet, so he's not trying to sell anything that he can't say that he has an experience of. I mean, he knows that guys can come here. You have, you know, guys like Kenny Burrows and Michael Strahan who went on to the NFL and had great careers. They're all guys who are alumni of Texas Southern. And that's what he's really trying to sell to these guys and why you need to come here and be part of this tradition that I'm reestablishing.
His previous head coaching job at Lane College took over a winless team. They won 5 games in the first year at Lane. Now he takes over his alma mater, Texas Southern. They were 0-11 a couple of years ago. They won 4 games last year and a good showing to begin 2009. Now, Johnny Cole's not going to be into any moral victories, but a good showing in 2009, especially from the defense.
I mean, the gap between Texas Southern and Prairie View is very small. I think if, you know, they play 10 times, they may go 5-5. Both of these teams are very good football teams.
K.J. Black in at quarterback on second down. Jason bounces it outside, has a block. Jason sprinting across midfield, loose football, but he was down at the 45.
You know, that's the one thing as a young running back that Michael Jason has to improve on. He fumbled the ball last year, and that's why he didn't get a lot of touches. But look at the speed that he hits that hole with. But then still, you have to hold on to the football. But this guy's an intense runner. I mean, you talk about Eric Dickerson, the guy that's big and strong and fast. I mean, Jason is that same type of guy. I think they just grow him like that in Texas.
Have a few of them. You talk about Adrian Peterson. He's from East Texas as well, Palestine, yep. Texas. Play clock down to zero. K.J. Black didn't notice.
Delay of game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
K.J. Black is a transfer from Western Kentucky. He started the last couple of games. He was a 1,000-yard passer in 2007 for Western Kentucky. Native of Louisville, but came to Prairie View A&M. And the competition pretty close between Bluford and Black. Jay Bluford, now a senior, been in the system a while longer, so he gets the nod. Apparently has the kinks worked out, so he's back in for first and 15. Blitz coming. Fulgham straight up the gut again.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, he's gotten a lot of mileage off of that blitz. That's going to be his favorite. He's had a big football game. This guy's been all over the place. 2 sacks, forced fumble. You know, they're a tackle for loss, a couple other tackles. This guy is a big-time player in the SWAC Conference.
104 tackles last year. 7 sacks already. 2 sacks, forced fumble tonight. Preseason first team all SWAC. Well, the run blitz sets up second down and 19. Jason gets the handoff again. Third down coming up. Obviously, the Panthers trying to run some clock, sitting on a 10-point lead.
Yeah, a 10-point lead. You have a very good defense. They're doing a smart thing. I mean, you have two very good running backs in 34, Michael Jason and also Donald Babers. I mean, Coach Frazier is a guy that was an option quarterback. So that means that he's used to this. Although he was a quarterback, he wasn't airing it out. So coming from Bowie State, he's always a big physical defense, run the football type of guy. And if he gets a lead, he wants to run that football and win the game. And that's good coaching. You don't have to try to do anything special. You don't get extra points for scoring. You just want to win the game.
Third down, running it again. Michael Jason. dives forward to the 43, so that'll bring up fourth down. But again, Prairie View A&M running the clock. Texas Southern will get it with under 6 minutes, needing two scores. The only points on the scoreboard for Texas Southern tonight came on an interception for a touchdown. That was on the first possession of the game by Prairie View A&M. So no points on the scoreboard since the early minutes of the ball game.
They've had their chances. They had a couple of real short missed field goal in the end of the second quarter and also the beginning of the third quarter. So they, you know, should have more points on the board. But hey, what should have happened, happened. That's the rule of football.
Low snap, Venturek gets it away. Webb fields it at the 10. Wrapped up there and dropped. There is a penalty flag on the play.
Like that initial call was holding against the Prairie View punt protection team.
In which case, Ventura would obviously have to kick it again.
Yeah, and Johnny Cole, of course, he wants to get as many re-kicks as he can because of Will Osborne and his exciting punt and kick return game.
Johnny Cole says, you want to kick it again? Fine with me.
Holding on the offense, number 34. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, fourth down.
Got your left side of the screen, number 34. You got a push in the back. And that's Michael Jason. That's your second string running back who's looked like he's pretty tired right there. He's kind of had the workload on his last running possession. But, hey, you're only a sophomore. You still have to get in there and play some special teams.
Ventura will hit it again from around the 35. Webb grabs it at the 20. Tries to cut it back. Anthony Webb is tripped up in the open field. Great special teams play.
Going to bed right now. I'm going to college. Thousands of people go to college in their pajamas every day. How is this possible?
Because you can go to college online without leaving your home. Using your computer to get an online degree is really smart and easy. In fact, people with a degree on average earn $1 million more in their lifetime. So, how do you find a good online school? Well, get your computer and go online right now. Education Connection is a free service that connects hundreds of people each day to the best online colleges. And you don't want to pick the wrong online school. So, ladies, slip on your cute little fluffy slippers and, guys, cover up, please. And log on now, and Education Connection will send you their free success kit stuffed with information on online schools, scholarships, even degrees that take the least amount of time. This is $100 value, and it's yours, free.
Log on now to 2EducationToday.com. That's 2EducationToday.com. 2EducationToday.com.
This is Maya, and if she doesn't look too happy, she isn't. Maya, like many people, has too much credit card debt. How about you? Do you have $5, $10, $15, or even $25,000 or more in credit card debt? Are your creditors harassing you at all hours? Are you tired of going through life feeling like Maya? I'm Todd Cook, founder of 800 Credit Card Debt. Day in and day out, we help people just like Maya. Regular people who got in over their heads in credit card debt and want their lives back on track. At 800 Credit Card Debt, we'll help you find a payoff plan you can live with. One that could work with your creditors to eliminate penalties, lower your interest rates, and even reduce what you owe. Don't let the word bankruptcy enter your thoughts. Call us, because you can pay off your credit cards and still have money left over each month. And the best part is, you'll feel like yourself again. Maya did. Make the call today.
Get rid of your credit card debt once and for all. Call 1-800-985-3191.
Healthcare.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson.
Were you or a loved one diagnosed with lung cancer? If so, we urge you to call now. The cancers listed on your screen may be linked to asbestos exposure. Exposure to asbestos in mills, factories, shipyards, or while working in the Navy, or as a plumber, electrician, plasterer, maintenance worker, or janitor may have put you at risk.
If you or a loved one was diagnosed with lung cancer, call 1-800-287-2501 for a free legal consultation. Again, that's 1-800-287-2501.
Maya, like many people, has too much credit card debt. How about you? Do you have $5, $10, $15, or even $25,000 or more in credit card debt? I'm Todd Cook, founder of 800 Credit Card Debt. We'll help you find a payoff plan you can live with, one that could work with your creditors to eliminate penalties, lower your interest rates, and even reduce what you owe. Call us, because you can pay off your credit cards and still have money left over each month.
Call 1-800-827-0135.
You're watching ESPNU's College Football Primetime SWAC Conference Football presented by Citi as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week at Reliant Stadium in Houston. Prairie View A&M leading Texas Southern 17-7. So once again, the situation for Johnny Cole and Texas Southern, an offense that has produced no points tonight, must come up with two scores in 5:06. Daunting task.
Well, you know, this is the time where most defenses go into that prevent defense, and I think they've been doing good all game. They stopped doing, so we'll see. Texas Southern make something happen.
Simone pressured, dumps it to Warren. Can't spin away from Dalvin Nettles, the defensive tackle, stopping Joseph Warren. Nettles with the tackle, on pace to graduate in 3.5 years with a degree in education administration. On second down and 5. Simone throws it incomplete, nearly picked. Flag on the play.
Boys to rush and then
holding offense number 7. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, second down.
Yeah, it looked like two guys on the same team were going for it. I think Max Century would have had a good chance of catching that football had it not been bumped by his teammate. Number 70 there is Big Matt Hardrick. He's guilty of the holding penalty. Now it's a second and long situation.
4.5 to go now on second down and 15. And we have a penalty on the play.
I promise you that's going to be the last penalty of the game.
Run snap. False start. Offense number 72. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
I'm going to remember you said that.
Now, in all fairness, you know, in college, of course, you get a couple of scrimmages, but they don't have the preseason to get warmed up. So these kids are out here for the first time. And with Texas Southern, you have a lot of transfers, a lot of new guys who haven't played together before. So you're going to have a couple more penalties, something you just have to work through as a coach.
Pressure on the edge. Check down to Warren, tripped up across the 20. To bring up third down, you would think Texas Southern in 4-down territory, perhaps, even though they're backed up inside their own 25.
Warren has been the workhorse in the backfield. He's done a good job of rushing and also with receiving coming out of the backfield.
Third down toss by Simone is incomplete. Intended for William Osborne. So we'll see what Texas Southern does on fourth down. The punting unit will come onto the field.
Yeah, still a lot of, well, not a lot of football left, but you still have right under 4 minutes. So you're hoping if you can get a quick three and out by your defense and then maybe get to better field position. Because right now, if you don't get it on fourth down and it's 4th and 11, you're pretty much giving up the football game. So smart move by Coach Cole, but you're really running out of time.
3 timeouts left for Texas Southern as well. Solomon hits it at the 13. High punt, short punt. Down to midfield. Monday evening, catch two college football shows on ESPNU. First at 5 Eastern, Crunch Time. We'll deliver the entire closing minutes and moments of all the significant and close college football contests from the previous weekend. Then at 6 Eastern, host Lowell Galindo and analyst Tom Luganville and Tommy Tuberville dissect and analyze the new polls and preview the next week's matchups on Inside the Polls, presented by 76. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Carter Blackburn with Eddie Robinson Jr. from Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas. Prairie View A&M University, about 50 miles from the campus of Texas Southern University in central Houston, Texas. Battling in the 25th annual Labor Day Classic, it's Prairie View A&M trying to move the chains and run the clock. Sitting on a 10-point lead right now.
When you talk about the job that Coach Frazier has done since he's gotten down here in 2004, he was 3-8, then 5-6, 3-7. Finally had that first winning record in 2007 of 7-3. And over the last 2 years, I mean, the Panthers are 16-4. The only team that he hasn't beat in the Southwestern Athletic Conference is, of course, the Grambling State Tigers. In the last 2 years, Grambling has represented the Western Division in the SWAC Championship game. So, of course, that big game against Grambling is what all of the Prairie View faithful are really eyeing for. But you still have to take care of your business like they're doing tonight of those other games along the way.
Second down carry will result in a loss of 4. And that Grambling State game is just around the corner. It is October 3rd, the big matchup after a trip to New Mexico State.
Now, of course, we talked about it earlier. Prairie View only has 9 games. They couldn't fill up their entire schedule. And after that New Mexico State game, they have 2 off weeks. So they're going to go back into a training camp mode and get ready for that Grambling State game. And that really is their game of the year, because the last year they finished 9-1. That one loss to Grambling kicked them out of the championship game. So they have to be able to, you know, win that football game. So
that game to be played at the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. And again, you go from September the 12th at New Mexico State to October the 3rd without a football game. What are the pros and cons of having that kind of hole in your schedule?
Yeah, I think it's a lot more cons than pros. I mean, but they're playing a Division I opponent in New Mexico State. So in case you're banged up, you get an extra week to heal. But I mean, that's not by the choice of Coach Frazier. He just couldn't get another team on the schedule. So you have to play with the cards that you have. He's going to go back into a training camp mode, and not to 2-a-days, but he'll give the kids a little bit of time off and concentrate on academics. But that's a game that once they get past this Texas Southern game, if they can pull this thing out, trust me, they're going to try to play New Mexico State hard and compete. But they're looking for that Grambling State game. That's the game that they have circled on their schedule. Every year they have the Tigers on the hook, and they just can't seem to pull it off. And it's cost them a chance to be in the SWAC championship game the last 2 years.
That was the only loss last season, was to Grambling State, as Bluford tucks it, runs on third down near the first. 9-1 mark for Prairie View A&M last year. Texas Southern 4-8 a year ago. Let's look at the Tigers' upcoming schedule, beginning at Louisiana Monroe.
Then they go to Texas College at home, and then at Texas State, and another Division I opponent in Rutgers. So they have a couple of weeks, 4 games, before they get back into SWAC play. And I think Johnny Cole likes it like that, because you can get your team ready before you start playing your conference game. So you're only 0-1 in the conference if they should go ahead and lose this football game. And so you still have a lot more football to play. And I think this will be the year that Texas Southern and Prairie View will both have a winning record. I really like what I see by Coach Cole and his Texas Southern University team.
Now, Andy, didn't you say about 2 minutes ago,
play of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down,
that was the last penalty we were going to see in the football game?
Well, what I said was, put on my politician tie.
Oh, anybody with the DVR is going back. Feel free to go back and check it out.
Well, we only had 2 minutes, but 2.5 minutes left. I thought for sure we could make it. But that might have been an intentional penalty to help you with the punting yardage.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Okay.
There
all
we
right.
go. So all I right. spin that around.
Well done, Senator Robinson. Osborne returns it to the 18, and so Texas Southern hoping for some kind of a Labor Day Classic miracle now. A minute 42, 2 timeouts. But the offense has produced no points. They need to score twice.
And this Coach Frazier defense, I mean, Highest Northern, I mean, they're geared up for this type of situation. All of these guys, these coaches, you know, Antoine Saul-Tool is the defensive backs coach, and he told me, hey, tell my grandmother that I'm in the booth coaching, because he said she watches the game all the time. And she's like, Antoine, I don't see you. Where are you? He said, well, I'm not on TV. I'm a coach, but he's not on the sideline. So I said, okay, I'll be sure to tell her back in Maryland that he's here and he's coaching at Prairie View and doing a good job.
Doing a good job. This is a new. Defensive intensity from Prairie View A&M. New defensive scheme for Texas Southern. You have to say the Tigers in that first game with a new defensive scheme under defensive coordinator Kevin Ramsey did an excellent job tonight. Obviously, it's looking like a Prairie View A&M win, but good effort by Texas Southern, especially defensively.
Yeah, I thought they played great defensively.
Marvell Nelson completes it on second down, moving the chains. Dixon makes the grab.
I mean, they gave up 17 points the last touchdown. They came onto the field at their own 20-yard line. So, you know, technically, they gave up 10 points. They also had an interception return for a touchdown. They shut down the running game of Prairie View and Donald Babers. So I don't think you can ask for much more as a coach. And Kevin Ramsey, man, this guy is a very good defensive coordinator. Of course, last year, L.C. Coles was a defensive coordinator, which is Johnny's older brother. He left and took the head coaching job at Stillman. And now they bring in the Kevin Ramsey. I mean, and that's a great replacement. This guy's been successful everywhere he's been. University of Georgia defensive coordinator, University of Tennessee, coached with the Arizona Cardinals. So he brings a wealth of experience and a good reputation and knowledge to this Texas Southern University program.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, number 72, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Well, after 15 straight years of Texas Southern defeating Prairie View A&M, including when Johnny Cole was the quarterback at Texas Southern in the first ever Labor Day Classic, after 15 straight years for Texas Southern, barring a miracle in the last 40 seconds, it will be Prairie View A&M winning 5 out of 6 matchups and now 3 straight in the Labor Day Classic.
And if you're a coach, that's called job security. Rule number one, beat your rival. And that's what Coach Frazier has been able to do since he's been at Prairie View.
It is truly a new day for Prairie View A&M football. Nelson pressured on second down. He will take the sack, forcing Texas Southern perhaps to take another timeout.
Big Dwayne Chapel, number 94, one of those redshirt freshmen that's been here in the program. Coach Frazier does a good job of trying to redshirt his entire freshman class. He really built this program from the ground up. You know, redshirt from a freshman, get 4 and 5 year seniors, and then I'll get good. And it took him a couple years to get things going, but hey, they're looking pretty good now.
5-yard penalty, still third down.
And appropriately a penalty with 12 seconds to go.
Well, I know, you know, the fans at home say, hey, ref, at this point of the game, why are you still calling penalties? But, hey, you know, the refs get graded. I mean, they have to call what they see. You know, they get in trouble if they don't call those fouls, you know?
Third down and long, semantics now with the clock rolling under 10 seconds. Nelson will tuck it and run, and that will be the final play of the 25th annual Labor Day Classic. It goes down as a 17-7 win for Prairie View A&M. Henry Frazier III and the Panthers celebrate their third straight victory over Texas Southern in the Labor Day Classic here in Houston. Well, Prairie View A&M gets a test from Johnny Cole's Texas Southern Tigers, but the Panthers get their first win of the year, first SWAC win of the year.
And that's big. I mean, you're 1-0 in the SWAC conference. You have your big game coming up next week, and of course the Grambling State game in a couple weeks. Things are looking good for Prairie View. And for Texas Southern, hey, they showed me that they can be a good football team, and I think they will have that winning record this year.
Once again, the final score, Prairie View A&M 17, Texas Southern 7. For Eddie Robinson Jr. and our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Carter Blackburn. Coming up next, it's SportsCenter U. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. We are College Sports. A 17-7 win for Prairie View A&M over Texas Southern. good night from Houston, Texas.